You Know What Do podcast on riotcast.com.
Oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you blow my mind.
Yeah, why is my thing not working?
I'm not hearing it either.
What the
fuck? Turn us down for the song?
Oh, yeah, but my mic isn't working. Why is my, hang on, stop, one second. Why is my mic not working, Scopio?
I can hear your mic.
You can
That's like your signature opening line of the episode.
I know.
That's
why is my mic
show.
Off?
It's literally driving me fucking batty. My mic is off right now. There it is.
I can hear you.
You're good.
Are you back? Are we back? Okay, good.
I think
good.
So.
All right. I think we're back.
It's like the game Mastermind. You have to figure out whose mic is off.
Well,
I think you turned down all our headphones.
Yeah, turn me up.
I got you right there.
Thank you.
How's that? Mm. Well, welcome, everybody.
Hi.
Hello.
To a very special late night edition of the You Know What Dude. It's the 9 o'clock version. Let's dim the lights and fucking
kiss.
Plus, Deepu gets all mad.
Ooh.
So let's dim the lights.
Oh, this is nice.
Someone got new lights.
Yeah, there we go. Oh, there we go.
A little nighttime, YKWD.
Oh, shit. A little nighttime. Look at. Oh, yeah, there we go.
I wish I brought candles.
It's the HBO edition.
Oh, we have candles. Bring them out, girls.
Where's my harem?
All right, we have a very special edition. Of course, we have Keith and the girl here tonight.
Hey, guys.
Which is always a special guest when we have you guys get to come out. The podcast of all podcasts.
Thank you.
Ooh. Does a podcast is pretty cool. We have Stavros.
Hello.
My little baby boy, my
That's
adopted
me.
Greek, Souvlaki.
That's good, Souvlaki. That's good.
Thank you. And we also have my pal Jason.
Hey.
Stand-up comedian, a.k.a. fabulous comic book artist.
Right.
Unbelievable. And good friend of mine now. We have Deepu, the mad fucking scientist.
Yo.
With a yellow, hairy ass for some reason.
Kneel before it.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
And take a whiff.
Kind of makes me want to do it. That's fine. Your confidence, your Indian confidence is fucking overwhelming. Indian
You're so easy.
And then we have Chris Scopo, spelled with a D. Nothing? dumb. No, I know. You're not. I'm going to lay off the dumb stuff for you, Chris.
Thank you.
If you stop being dumb. Is that cool? Is that a deal?
That's tough to do.
Yeah, there's the thing with Chris. He's not really dumb. He's very smart in specific shit. You know what I mean?
Baseball.
Like, so you have to talk to him in that language.
That's actually, baseball.
Baseball.
Yeah. Baseball. He is like Rain Man. Yeah.
I really am. Yeah.
Yeah, it's like baseball or like you know, guy shit.
You don't even know what guy shit is. You just
no
take
because
guy
I'm
because
yeah. I'm not really that guy. You know what I mean? I do a lot of guy shit, and I grew up with five uncles that were guy shit. But I was never. I swear to God, I relate to Caitlyn Jenner. I was different inside. I'm like,
are you
too.
Coming out, Bobby? Is that what's going on?
No, I'd be a fucking awful woman.
No, you're like the Boston
you're cute,
Gerber
dude.
Baby.
Could you imagine if I came out as
I'd
a transgender? Yeah, what?
Oh my God, I could see you in a wig right now.
Absolutely, that's
with
what I'm thinking.
Sequins?
Could you?
Oh, you're fabulous.
It would be such a fucking nightmare.
But it'd be a beautiful nightmare
for some dressmaker. Just
oh no, you're making
Lane
your own
Bryant.
Clothes.
You could get sponsored by Lane Bryant. I think
that's
You'd
not nice to say.
It's not. It's not. Plus size. You could be the first.
I don't
plus
know what
size
Lane Bryant is. What is Lane Bryant? I just laughed for no reason.
It's a plus size woman.
It made sense. It's yeah, like, that's an odd word.
Oh,
that, that doesn't fit.
No, he was like, that's an insult. I'll just laugh.
Yeah. Is Lane.
It's a plus-size women's clothing show.
I want to go there with a fucking flip cam.
You've definitely done more than one gay role. Like, I can see a wig.
I've done... Let me see how many gay roles
you
I've
did
done.
Just give a chef a hand job while eating ribs.
That's not gay.
TV show.
That's not gay. That's
gay
committed.
But also, being
That's
transgender
different.
Is
That's
not
right.
gay.
That's true. It's not gay.
In Trainwreck, you were very committed.
I was
you
committed.
Were.
And the first role... I moved to New York City... I got a phone call from this guy, Matt Frost. He said, I love your acting reel. Your comedy's okay. swear to God. He goes, if you ever move to New York, I'd like to try to represent you. I book comedy gigs, but I want to become a manager. He was with Barry Katz at the time, New York right. Entertainment. And I remember I met with him and I met with Barry. And I remember Barry going, I'm not going to work with you. And I was like, hi, good. But this kid got me this audition. I book it for a movie right out of the gate.
Wow.
I go in for
Does
the Italian.
Does that make you cocky?
Well, I went in for the Italian Andrew Dice thing. Mm. You know what I mean? And it was.
Shit. Oh, shit. We got Wil Sylvince dropping
in. Oh, he brought
in.
His penis. That matches
this room.
I knew
what
it. I knew it was pointy and had a wick at the end. I just knew it. I don't know
what
why.
What fucking Haitian float did you. What, is that what you came here on? Nothing? All right. What is it, man?
He stole it.
Get out of here.
That's Why a are you lamp? Yelling that at him? He doesn't know that.
No, no, Will, get out of here. Leave the lamp. Thank you very much. All right. Now,
what else do you do with your bare hands?
There's a plug.
No one on the podcast knows what the fuck's going on.
No, we have a camera. We have a camera right here. We have
can the camera get that?
Yeah, we got it. Yeah.
That's beautiful. What?
That is the worst lamp I've ever seen in my life.
That adds so little light.
This is the best time to present this.
It is.
It's just wood. It's just wood with a little light
hey,
up.
Hey, bro, is there any way?
Just wood.
Right here.
Stavros.
Say just wood.
I did. No one can hear you, Will. You're not on a microphone.
No, everyone can
hear
you.
Can you get on the
microphone
over here, please? Get over there. Get over there, dum-dum. We were just talking about how you weren't coming on the show. But now you're on the show.
Thank you, Liz.
Thanks, Liz. Thanks for fucking sabotaging my show with a weird fucking Star Trek light. Now what am I? How
it matches this room, man. The red, the freaking.
That's
ambience.
About it. That stop right there. That's it.
The ambient.
The what?
Ambiance. You're looking for ambiance.
The what?
Ambiance. I said ambiance.
No, don't. The rule in this room. You never help him with a word.
Okay.
You understand that? How's he going to learn
right.
if you got fucking
let him struggle.
Little ambience. Fucking nerd comic from Baltimore and helping him?
I
right?
said ambiance.
No, you didn't.
You said ambience.
Ambience.
No, I did not
like
say
a
that.
Sleeping
anyway.
Play the tape back.
Play the tape.
This isn't fucking
Lauren
WKRP in Cincinnati. I have no tapes. Like, nothing? All right. Next one.
I'm like, where's he
going to
go with this?
Where the handkerchief is. How come the handkerchief ain't on this show?
It's right
is
there.
Anybody,
right
is anybody there. Dropping hip bombs on this show?
Well, that's
nobody
well,
knows.
So far, you it's just you.
Will, can you lighten your skin? We can hardly see you.
Oh.
Listen, no. He
who
he
said
really,
that?
Take
who
your
said
hat
that?
Off.
Who said that?
You got to take
just
your hat off.
Less.
Who said that?
Deepu.
I'm not kidding. That. We don't have the. And I'm not being racist.
Why are you so mad?
Your beautiful chocolatey skin doesn't come up.
You don't need to see my face. I'm not supposed to be here. I bought the stupid lamp.
Just put the hat up a little bit. A little more. Right there. We're good. That's
there
it.
Go.
That's all we need.
Will, did you really build that lamp with your
I did,
bands?
Man.
Who's when did you build it, though?
All your white guys sounded like I can't tell who's
Will,
talking.
Will, did you really build that lamp with your yes. bare hands?
Well, answer the question, Will.
Can you tell me what type of
all y'all sounded
a triangle?
All y'all sounded like and
we
looked
sound
like.
So
you look
different.
Like a mini Bobby Kelly.
Well, that's true.
That
holy
is my,
shit.
That's,
if Bobby ran all the
son.
Money.
Dude, that's his son.
If you were here all the time.
Hey,
I want to.
I'm going to tell you this right now. Stop screaming. The microphones work. All right.
If you ran out of money,
thank you.
You look like Bobby Kelly doing really bad.
What about me says doing really bad?
Everything.
The crooked
everything.
Glasses.
I don't know the glasses are crooked.
Do you know he writes for?
I don't give a damn if he write for Jesus.
Do you write
I
for
did,
Jesus?
I did the Matthew that gospel. That was me.
Sweet gig, man. That's great. I love that one.
Do you know
great
what residuals? He actually? He's the showrunner for was. For Two and a Half Men and Two Broke Girls.
But
he's a showrunner.
He don't write
right.
parts for black people
yeah,
or Haitians.
He only writes parts for people in twos.
Yeah.
That's right.
It's and true.
Two bitches.
And that was very fast, by the way, and deserved more. Okay? The delivery was perfect, too. Yeah. You didn't fucking spit it out. You went twos.
That was great.
It was fucking great. You, all right? He, the black guy in Two and a Half Girls.
The black guy.
Two Broke Girls.
The black guy.
Dude, there's four people in the cast.
He's not casting them.
I'm yeah. writing. I wrote them all black, but they
writes.
Changed it.
See? Yeah,
I wrote it as an all black show.
It was two black girls.
It was I wish I could be racist. Two broke.
Hold on.
We know what you're trying to do. We know what you got.
You said you wish you could be racist? Is that something you have to wish for?
Yeah.
Some people wish for the good old days. Not on this network.
That's what the offer, right? That's not right, guys.
That's racism.
Racist cast.
So anyways, thank you for the lamp. Can I just be honest?
First of all, you don't
and
like
please,
the lamp.
Keith, I want to ask you a question.
I'll tell you why it's weird right away. We brought you guys a lamp.
Bobby, I didn't want to make this
just
weird.
Just a little smaller well, version of that lamp. Just
I left it downstairs. I hope it's still there. It's ridiculous.
But the way Will said it last week was like a desk lamp that you could just put it on the desk.
That was your limited imagination thinking. I thought that.
This lamp belongs in fucking Superman's cave. What the fuck is this? The fuck?
It definitely has a fortress of solitude.
Don't say you don't
vibe.
Want it. I'll take it back, Bobby.
Buddy, I don't know. No, you're leaving it now. I'm keeping that. We're going to all fucking sign your lamp.
You can't sign that.
That's everybody that comes in is going to sign the fucking lamp.
Oh, that's nice.
All right.
All right. That's what we're doing. And then we're going to raise money for Haiti at the end of the year. We're going to sell it on eBay, and
that's
we'll raise
idea.
Money for Haiti.
Are you
How's
serious
that?
Or that's a joke?
Buddy, I'm serious. Not for Haiti, but for an American cause. But listen, we'll raise money. You want, is Haiti,
yeah,
is
man,
that your cause?
That's a great cause. I love
but
that.
Are they still in trouble?
No,
I mean,
Sean
Penn came back.
Are there still racist white people?
Does Wyclef still want to do shit there?
Right.
Yeah, does Wyclef, is he making watches now or is he in Haiti? What is happening? Yo, this watch.
great Wyclef.
We took it too far.
I took it too far. First of all, he doesn't have an accent like that.
Yeah,
that was Dante. He did Dante.
No, Bobby, I like to I tell guys how to pimp their chicks out.
Can you do my favorite accent, please?
What's Which that?
One? You know.
I can't do that. I do it with my
accent. Audie Lang?
No, yes. I do.
Audie Lang.
I can't do it.
Oh, and the Russian another car.
All right, we got Keith and the girls on. I can't.
Is it Israeli? Maybe it's a tough Israeli guy.
It's already lying. I can't do
That's
it.
That's good. You had it. You had it. Yeah.
I got a black guy and a Jew and a fucking another Jew and then a Greek. It's like a fucking All in the Family episode.
That's great. That's very.
You should do your whole show in Audie Lang, man.
Yeah. Go Audie listen Lang. To Audie Lang. Yeah. How's that?
That exists.
He's actually he's way funnier.
That's true. That's true.
What the fuck?
I can't take
this,
that away.
Here's the problem with the lamp, and I'm gonna acknowledge this. We'll go around the room, and please give me your honest answer.
All right.
The lamp part of it doesn't really help me.
Yeah.
Like the light. Yes. Hang on.
Okay, it's an art.
Okay, just call it art. Don't call it a lamp.
It's barely
if you
a lamp.
Walked in and said, I made this art piece for you, I would be like, holy shit, man. Thank you so much for the triangle light. But you called it a lamp. It's not a fucking lamp. I think the definition. Can somebody look
that's
up
a, that's
lamp?
That's a night light.
I messed up.
Look
maybe,
on the computer lamp.
Maybe that's what
it's an R on your phone.
It's an art. That's
it's an art. It's a piece of artwork.
Okay, it's a piece. I'll take art. I'll take art, but I will not take lamp.
I never said lamp.
You literally said lamp as soon as you walked in.
I said
reverse
tape.
Take
a lamp.
Let's go WKRP. Reverse that tape. let's go Full House. One of those dads had a little workshop downstairs.
So, is this going to trash the lamp day? Is this what it is?
Bring
the
lamp.
Trash the lamp day?
If you did say it was a piece of art, he would go like, oh, shit, and there's a little light from the bottom.
Yeah.
He would have been impressed.
Right. That would have been a thing for Bobby. He's not that smart.
Maybe this is a lamp like in Haiti.
Where? No, this lamp belongs on fucking a planet on Star Trek, the old one. It's the light.
A lamp. Hold on.
There's a lamp
in your office.
On your
Who's that you doing?
I'm doing fucking Spock.
There's a lamp.
Because apparently you didn't know it was William Shatner. I'll go for Spock.
Captain.
I don't understand. You didn't. First of all, you didn't make
Can
that
for
me.
Can you do Audie Lang at Spock?
Captain, it's not logical. It's not logical not at bad. All. It's not logical at all. The fucking alien, you fucked her. She's green. And, I mean, what the fuck? You're going to get some type of herpes or something. When I was on Howard, I fucked a green bitch. She wasn't green. I was just fucking on heroin. And fucking stole it. Anyway, we'll be right back. Fucking national fucking shit on lamp day with these fucking. Guy made me a triangle lamp with fucking Haitians are crazy. What the fuck? Why don't you go make some houses in your fucking hometown instead of fucking making white people lamps?
Wow.
Do the whole show.
Shut the fuck up. No. Stop repeating yourself. Listen.
Maybe it's just a conversation piece.
It is a
conversation. It sure is.
It's a giant triangle.
Of this show.
Yeah, I mean.
next time if you bring a giant triangle to somebody's house, you'll understand the effect.
I don't
Take your
get
time.
It.
Take your time. Take your time. How many I don'ts you need in a sentence?
I don't get it.
It's a piece of artwork. Look, your pockets in your shirt, I don't get it.
They're the whole thing. They actually don't push the whole shit glasses. In there.
They have function.
They have
it's
function.
To hide your nipples. That's about it.
First of all, anyways, what were we talking about before? Fucking
yeah, Will just came in here and just completely hijacked the show.
That's called Will.
Hijacked nothing, man. I bought in a nice.
You
piece
look
of
like
artwork.
A hijacker on the African coast.
I bought
I'm
a
the
nice
captain
piece
now.
Of artwork.
You look like
saying?
You're about to storm
for
a mall.
My good friend, who I find super funny. He just
thank you.
He just crushed what? Downstairs and he crushed around the corner.
Buddy, I want to say something. I really love you, man, and I know your heart's deep.
Shut up.
I really.
He's like, I'll take the money right now. I'm not going for the bonus round.
Right.
That was
I'm trying to just set up, Bobby. I know that's all your jokes. I know your rhythm. I know your rhythm.
Buddy, apparently you don't know my taste.
It's so sexy the way you guys talk to each other.
Buddy,
there is definite tension in the room.
I just want to. I really want to. I just want to take that home and bring it in, and I just want to hear my wife go. No. It's not happening.
But Will knew my rhythm.
I want to impale someone with it.
That lamp is going to go in the corner, and everybody will sign it. Is that okay if people sign it?
I think it's signed.
And then at the end of the year, we'll...
Who's going to sign it first?
You. Dumb.
Why I got to sign it?
Because you're the artist.
You
got
to sign your artwork.
He's like, I want nothing to do with it. It's ridiculous.
That's why he's giving it away.
I want to really get down to this. No, I don't believe you made it just for me. I fucking think you were fucking driving by Jersey City. You saw some fucking old disco lady cleaning out her house because she can't afford her fucking house anymore.
You ever seen the clock I made for Patrice's mom?
No. Oh, shit. You're going to bring Patrice up. Okay, no, I didn't.
Exactly.
Please tell me if it's a fucking triangle.
Is that no. It's a clock.
A triangle clock.
It's a clock of Patrice I made for his mom. Are you having a stroke?
He's making fun
of you.
How
are you? Are you having a titty attack?
I want to call Patrice's mom right now.
Right
how's
now.
Your triangle clock?
Your phone's over there.
No, he's got.
He ain't got no more minutes on his phone. No, he ran out of daytime, nighttime minutes.
What is it? 92?
Can you go to the Skype on the computer? See if that's up. See if the Skype's up. We have an account on that.
Skype-o.
Call her from that so we can all hear.
He's bringing up minutes like it's the Dukes that has.
I know, right?
Anyways, this is a very. Hang on 1 second. This is, he said, what?
Can you call it right now or what? I put it on speaker.
We want everybody to hear.
I got a good speaker, though.
Are you okay?
I don't think Skype's going to work on that.
No? Can you use that for a second?
We got to sign in and stuff.
I forget it.
Yeah. Exactly. That's what I'm talking about.
Anyways, I want to go to the chat room
real
quick.
You can FaceTime.
Have they, what?
FaceTime if you want to see it.
No, because if it goes through the computer, everybody she hears everybody.
It's calling.
And everybody can hear her.
I'll repeat everything she says. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me? What the fuck?
Oh, Bobby, it's not that good. Are you calling her?
No, I ain't calling. I'm calling Steve.
Steve who?
Steve. Yes, I'm calling the dummy.
Is she on? Put the phone to the microphone.
The speakers on
put
the back.
Put the phone to the microphone.
Yeah, that's
the
what.
Speakers
that's
on the back of it.
Hey, Miss O'Neill, how you doing? First of all, before you say anything crazy,
don't say nothing crazy about white people.
Miss O'Neill, I got a bunch of people that's listening to you. So
tell her it's me. I'm not a bunch of people, you asshole.
It's Robert Kelly.
Sure about that?
Well, you can.
I should be at my worst, then, right?
Say it again. It's Robert Kelly. He's at his worst, so you're even.
Tell her you're on my podcast.
I'm on Robert Kelly's podcast.
You're getting her in trouble at work.
What's a podcast?
Can I talk to her, please? Can I talk to her? All right, listen. Hi, honey. How are you?
I'm good.
I need...
You guys don't call me. You need to call me frequently.
I'm sorry, Bubba. You're absolutely right. I'm a piece of shit, and you're right. I suck.
Exactly.
Is this another lamp question? People have been calling me all day about this fucking lamp.
Yeah. I'm gonna.
Keith
is somebody? Excuse me. Is somebody? Georgia.
Peach cobbler right now.
Georgia. Is somebody breaking in? Why is the dog freaking out? Are you okay?
The dog can smell meat.
Listen, listen, Georgia. I want to ask you something.
Where is the nearest Popeye?
Okay.
Georgia. I want to ask you something.
Yes.
Okay? Okay. All right. Can you shut that dog up? No, I'm kidding.
Is Will Georgia. An artist?
Will just came, Will said he gave you a clock. He made you a clock. Okay?
He made me a clock.
Now, that's not the question. The question is, he made me a lamp. Okay? Now, does it look? Does your clock look like he got it, like from a time machine in the future?
No, it's actually very nice and cool. Oh, wait a minute, Cookie, come here.
You think Aunt Jemima's gonna be mean about this?
She barks when the doorbell rings on the TV. She's retarded.
You can't use that word anymore, Georgia.
We on TV.
You say doorbell on the plasma.
She's very challenged. All right, listen. So can you please text me a photo of the clock that he made for you? It's Patrice's face?
Yes, I called Patrice's face out.
It's very creative. It's a beautiful clock.
All right, well, wow. He just walked in with a 4.5-foot triangle.
Yeah, but she sounds
lamp.
Like she's talking about a challenged person.
You understand that? It's a triangle. It's a 3-dimensional triangle lamp with a red light at the bottom.
No, that's it.
Thank you.
I got the clock. Sorry.
All right. Well, listen.
So wait a minute now.
Oh, shit. Yep.
Do you like the lamp?
It's not a lamp. It's definitely not a lamp. Well, I don't like. If I needed to read, I would not like this lamp. If I wanted to kill a hooker in 1987, I would love this lamp.
Judge Wapner at 7. It's definitely not a lamp.
Oh, it's yeah. Like Robert Downey Jr. should be blowing a guy next to this.
It's still 1987 on her clock. It doesn't
hang
work.
Hang up on a high.
Listen, I'm going to try to call you back on Skype in a little bit because we can't really hear you, and I want to make sure we hear you. So if you see a weird number come up, it's me.
Now everyone's calling.
All right? So pick it up.
All right, I will.
That's all how right. The movie Scream
I love
started.
You. I'll talk to you in a little bit.
Bye-bye. I love Bye. You guys, too. Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
She's the best.
She's the coolest.
See, did she say anything about the? She said it was a lovely clock.
Yeah, I wish.
Nice piece
just
of artwork.
You made one thing that
shit,
wasn't
I could definitely.
I made a gang of artwork, man. Stop disrespecting my artwork,
buddy.
Man.
I don't listen,
before
man.
I get up in this bitch.
Listen, can I just? I want to say something.
He stopped on a photo on his phone. That he pulled up, ready to go. Look at that. Just look at that.
Can I say something? I want to say thank you for the lamp.
You want to?
Lamp art. I would
like
I know,
you
wanna, I,
like
I
you
am.
Wish you was racist?
You're one of the sweetest guys
you say
I know.
Things that you could just
Can
be.
I say something without you yapping?
You sweet motherfucker.
Thank you. Look at me. Just fucking.
Look in my eyes.
Give me a moment. You're one of the sweetest guys I know.
You got a big heart.
And
man.
I fucking love you. Thank you for the art lamp. And I'm going to put it in the studio. We're going to sign it. And we're going to raise money for your people.
Thank you, Robert.
All right, for the mentally challenged. We're going to fucking.
For
speech impediment people, we're going to fucking. Why you? We're going to fucking raise money for you, dude. All right? Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I'm going to put it over there. Now, I want to get back to.
All right, I'm leaving.
Why are you leaving? You can stay. Stay.
Why you?
Let's stay. Where are you going?
I'm going to go make. I got to make another lamp.
No,
you ain't making
it.
Please,
light bulb this
please
time.
Stay.
This one went over so well.
The next pentagon.
I know, it's just a shape.
I gotta go hurry up and make a circle.
It's a circle lamp that just rolls around this house.
I'm making an octagon for Dana White. Listen,
who's Dana someone White? Else thinks about it.
Dana White is the president of the UFC. Anyways, did you see the fucking footage? Of the woman.
Oh, I don't want to talk about that. Ugh.
Fucking two women fighting, middle-aged right. women. I don't know, white chick, black lady. Black lady has a is getting attacked by this white chick. Black lady has a dog. Hits the chick with, whips the dog at the chick.
Oh, wow. Whoa.
I mean, hits the other woman with the dog.
What happened to the
on
dog?
On the it's hanging by its neck.
Oh.
And she's walking down the street with it by its neck, Jesus. Like it's a weapon.
Is it a chihuahua? Because then I get it.
No, it was one of those fucking yappy little English.
It was like a Jack Russell Terrier.
How did it
start? Jack,
why
no,
did,
it was a little bigger than that. Those Scottish shitty terriers.
How did it start? Yorkie started the fight.
I don't. It didn't show that. It's. Could go find it on the computer.
Calm
you
down,
find it.
Man. Calm down.
He's sorry, saying here. It doesn't seem like the dog started it.
Do it on a piece of paper. It's easier to use the mouse. It's fucking.
Wow.
I've never seen anything like this.
Hmm.
How many times did you watch it?
I watched it once, and I can't really watch this shit.
Would it be
anymore.
On YouTube? Yeah.
Just go to Google. Holy shit.
He's dumb. Dude, what the hell? I said D at the beginning, it was for dumb.
Why can't you watch this stuff anymore? You're older, or you have a family?
I don't know. Something happened where I don't like watching people get hurt or fucking violent. I don't like violence. I don't like when little, like a dog or a kid.
That's the worst.
You finally transitioned.
I don't know. I don't know what it is. I just don't like it. Or I know what I really don't like is when people, like skateboarders, are coming down. They hit their nuts on a pole.
Right.
Or fucking snap their knee, and they're like, ugh, I don't want. Fuck.
Do you think
that.
Like maybe you never look liked one of these it thumbnails. And now you can just admit
Hold
it?
Hold on. Look at one of these thumbnails and tell us which one is it.
Dog attack. There's so many dog attack videos on YouTube.
It's lady hits
Let's
lady
start
with
at the
dog.
Top and go down.
Don't put dog attack. I never said dog attack. I said lady hit a fucking lady with the dog.
I love when the boss. Why
would, where the fuck? Work
While you're there, Google lamp.
Dog attacked lady by other lady. What the fuck? Where'd you learn how to Google, you oaf? I'm sorry.
Where'd you learn to Google?
Hang on.
You know, the Boston only comes out when you talk to him.
I know. Well,
what the fuck are you doing?
I love Scopo.
The Buddha comes out when you start
doing
that.
Did you find it?
All right,
here we go.
There it is.
Oh,
wow. Okay.
This was wait, you can't watch
this,
but
we have
to. Full screen that bitch.
This is He's talking
about
the dog.
Imagine Will hosting
We're
a clip show.
We're just going to watch
full
the video
screen that bitch.
On the podcast.
This is a great news about it.
Go back. Escape and then go back.
There it is.
Oh my God. Oh
Whoa!
Oh my God. Wait.
Holy.
She walks away.
I want to see this.
Oh, man.
She walks away.
With the dog by the neck.
Watch it again.
Can you go to the real video and not the news?
Watch this. Look at the dog.
Oh, dog attack. Whoa.
Jesus.
Oh, that's the worst.
Wait, watch this. She walks away with the dog like a weapon. It's still choking it.
Still up. Oh. And then it looks like she puts it almost behind her shoulder like you're carrying heavy groceries.
Is
this Walid Qualif?
What?
Walid Qualif?
I don't know who the fuck. Is that nuts?
That is nuts, but I feel like that was her rage that just like she believed she still had a weapon in her hand, so she was just handling it like that.
And then,
like,
I can picture Bobby doing
just dragging it. Look at her. She's just dragging it along.
She's dragging it.
Ugh.
You get heated.
Some people
Yeah, but she's still dragging it. Like, she's in the middle of the street, and it's still by its neck. Like, she's holding like a purse.
Not like some people can't have babies. She can't have pets.
I think some people don't understand that pets are
I think
are
babies
actually...
are on that list, too, by the way. I think you're a little further with that. Yeah. She can't have chipmunks. She can't have a weasel.
A chinchilla.
She can't have
Forget
neighbors.
About bunnies. Yeah, oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
I gotta be honest.
How you
when
find
I have
that?
A baby, I understood that... it's different. That's a responsibility.
I mean, how fucking... But the other chick got so freaked out that she got hit. Could you imagine getting hit with a dog?
Who knows what the fuck is next? You leave. They win.
Right. You start with a dog and then you work your way up.
Yeah.
That
can't be the end. You're willing to swing your fucking dog. Yeah. I don't know what you're beating me with your clit. I don't know what the fuck
weapon.
Is next.
But
what was going through her mind that she had to hit her with the dog?
Something like, fuck you.
That's probably it, yeah.
You ever get hit with the dog,
I think it was, I really want to hit this lady with a dog.
I want to hit this bitch with a bitch. Yeah. That's what happened, yeah.
That's fucked up. It would make sense if it was the other woman's dog. That would make sense.
See, that
would make
sense. That's very disrespectful.
So this is her own dog.
Here's your dog, bitch.
Her best friend.
Yeah.
And she hit her with the dog.
Right. No, I made that up, but yeah. I'm not news. I don't know. I just saw that. Don't pass that on. Why are you staring at me?
No, you know what? Pass it on. Retweet. Yeah. Go for it.
I've seen Bobby hit a guy with Scopo before.
What did you fucking write for this week? Are you taking a fucking class?
You guys are all set.
He had the bullet points to his show, so he had time to write. The rest of us had to come up with shit on the spot.
Rare.
Fucking really doing very well today, Deepu.
Oh, thank you, buddy.
Well,
you
when he got the bullet points for the show, he could do that.
All right.
Well, was the bullet points. He come up with a gang of shit.
If you say bullet points one more time, I'm going to fucking hit you
with
your lamp.
With a bullet point?
So anyways.
Set list. He had the set list for the show.
I want to get into this.
No.
First of all, Chemda, you lost some weight. You were working out.
I didn't recognize you when I saw in the street earlier.
You look beautiful.
Thank
I passed on 6th Avenue, but she barely said hi to me.
Because she
got
see you.
She got the new, her new you, her new her. So now her new her don't talk to certain people.
You look.
But when she was a fat mess, she used to say hi to you all the time.
Jesus God.
Now she's mess. Hot and delicious. She walks right by me.
Can you not? Can you
fat
not?
Mess?
He just described me like I was, I don't know, a hot meal. Yeah. Now
look,
she's
I
hot
got hungry.
And
like you was hot before, but now that you lost the weight, I'm like, oh shit, she was
you,
a fat
you,
mess.
You look
I was,
great.
I liked the fat mess before. You,
but now she's fat. Christ.
But now she's delicious.
You all right?
Your
shut the fuck
mess.
Up. Listen.
You look like a meal of Patrice's mom
gotta,
cooked.
I gotta get to you. All right, enough okay. with the fucking quips. Let me just get to what you because there's a reason why you're here. You guys are doing something very interesting.
Yes, we're losing weight.
No.
And now we will twirl.
How do you do it?
I want to tell you about my morning
Hang
yoga
on one second.
Routine,
Keith,
everybody.
This is not this is the new studio. Put use the coaster.
Oh,
listen,
sorry.
I no, I'm kidding.
$35
the coaster's
going to
ruin. What is this?
Right. It's liquid glass.
The shellac.
liquid glass.
I give you guys 2 weeks before you quit giving a fuck.
Yeah, yeah.
Please, enough with the quips. Yes.
thank you. You guys are here because you guys are going on tour.
Yes.
You guys are doing a tour.
The Fat Mess Tour.
You don't do stand-up, right?
Right.
Well, are you going to do stand-up?
We're going to do live Keith and the Girl show every night, 10 cities, back-to-back, 10 nights.
Wow. Where are the cities?
We're doing the Comedy Store in L.A.
One.
We're doing Curious Comedy.
Two.
Cobb's Comedy.
Three.
We're starting in Seattle. So Seattle, Portland, San Francisco,
Four.
L.A., Vegas.
Five.
What's next?
San Diego?
Albuquerque.
Six.
Albuquerque.
Denver's in there.
Seven.
Oklahoma.
Eight.
And Phoenix.
You're doing Oklahoma?
Yes.
Wow. City.
We're closing in Oklahoma.
Now, did you go in and get analytics? How did you find out what cities to go to do this? Is this because you're popular, most popular in these cities?
Not really, because the thing is we couldn't do complete analytics. I mean, it just has to be like the U.S., and we're driving overnight. So when we're done with the show, we're getting on the bus.
Wow.
Bus driver's driving all night.
Really?
We wake up in a new city.
It's
like a
roll.
Real bus tour, like
Keith,
with bunks and...
Is your name on the side of the bus, or is it just a rock and roll bus?
No, it's just we're renting a tour bus.
And driver, are you driving it, or are you getting
a
driver?
No, we got a driver. His name
That's
is
great.
Wally. He's awesome.
I know Wally.
You do?
No.
He's very.
He's
gonna
popular. Get you lost.
Have you done this before? Have you been on a? Have you toured
not
on
a
bus?
Not a tour per se. We've done Keith and Girls shows.
Like one off.
In the U.S., overseas.
We did cruises.
We did a cruise, but never a tour.
I did a tour when I was singing, but I didn't produce it. I just was hired on it.
Right.
So I've been on a tour bus and tour van and like shitty and better situations.
So have you? Have you slept on the bus?
I did one tour bus tour for 30 days. I did a European.
How great is it? Isn't it the best?
Not really.
You didn't like it? Was it a nice tour bus?
It was a beautiful tour bus, and I had like the more comfy tour bus for some reason. Like I was the lead singer in the opening, and they
wow.
like full
so
respect.
So they gave it to me for some reason.
But I think it's a very specific mindset of
yeah.
you're going to be alone and with a lot of people, and you have to like really get along, and there's a lot of hurry up and wait, and it's a lot of work. But yeah, it's a lot of fun because it's exciting. Like the crowd is
yeah,
there. You
yeah.
get to like go live. You get to do the thing that you're doing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I loved it. The best sleep I've ever got was on a tour bus. Because you're literally in these little capsules.
Those I love.
And you're just getting rocked
to sleep.
I mean, every once in a while, you're like, if we crash, my head's going to be in my asshole.
Yeah.
Right. You know what I mean?
But that's why you got to sleep feet first.
Yeah, you got to sleep feet first. But
and also, everyone's mad at me because I said no pooping on the bus. But you're not
Whoa.
Allowed to poop on the bus.
What? You're really not.
You hold
Thank
on to your poop.
Oh, my
what
God.
Are you gonna
Thank
do?
You.
Because you can't, if you poop, you just can't shit on the bus because it's all there. It's just right there. But you stop, which is fun. You stop at a Walmart. You stop at a truck
right.
stop, which is awesome, too.
Yeah.
Because you get to go, truck stops across the U.S. You don't understand how fucking amazing and the fucking crazy shit you'll find.
They have, like,
right.
showers that you
showers.
Can rent.
Showers.
They
you
have.
Rent.
I know. It's so exciting, you guys. We get to rent a shower.
Every time I get.
Wow. Showers that truckers use. Sounds
yeah.
great.
You could pretend to be, like, a
really,
lot lizard or what are they called?
They're
yeah.
really nice, man. I'm telling you. You think it's shitty.
Sounds
but
shitty.
They're really nice.
You know how, for example, you guys can see whatever movie you want at any time?
Right.
If you happen to stop at a truck stop, they might have a movie
yep.
playing specifically right then, and that one you can see.
Or that's a gamble, it sounds like to me.
Yeah. Or you can buy a DVD player and a DVD and a CB radio and whatever antennas
CB
you need.
CB radio?
Dude, let me tell you something. CB radios are the fun. If you're ever doing a road gig, you should get a CB radio.
You're a regular WKRP.
There's nothing funnier
than listening to the truckers.
Than listening to truckers.
Right. They and swear like fucking
they're the fucking worst. Yeah. And talking to them. If you get one talking to you, they'll talk all night because they're fucking trying not to fall asleep. Right. You know what I mean?
And they're so racist.
There's no
limits.
There's no. I'm telling you. They're the racist motherfuckers on the planet.
You should totally
truck drivers.
Talk to them.
Mm. And I love truck
and
drivers.
That's all around the world. That's a universal thing.
Yeah.
Too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like they're driving an Xbox.
Right.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yes.
Could be a 14-year-old boy.
Buddy.
I fucked your mom. Over.
But they'll talk to you all night. And they'll have these deep conversations. I mean, it's fucking amazing. You should get a CB radio. They're nothing. You should get a CB radio.
Okay. I used
and
to
late
have one
night,
as a
just
kid.
Fucking just get on it. And you'll hear, yo, where you going down, getting them down. You know, sloppy Joe, man. You're like, what the fuck did you just say? Oh, dear.
I used to have one as a kid, and I learned all of the swear words that I know from listening to that CB
radio,
all the truckers.
What would be your CB name, your handle?
CB Johnny Dick.
Johnny Dick. What would be yours?
Lizard Bitch.
Really?
I don't fucking know. I never thought of this.
Call
first.
Hot Mess.
You're gonna need one.
Really?
You're gonna
hot
need
mess.
One. Fat
hot
mess.
Mess.
Hot Mess.
My friend's podcast.
Yeah. What would yours be?
That would be like something weird, like Chat Daddy or something.
Like Chat Daddy.
What would yours be? Lamp Builder.
That's it.
Heart Maker.
What would it be?
All that. Mine be.
He wouldn't say he's Haitian. That's for sure.
Haitian dude. Haitian.
Yeah, that'd go over well.
He probably ironic.
That would be yours, Haitian dude.
What would be yours?
Me, I'd be called
Baby 69.
I'd be Two Ton Tessie.
Two Ton Tessie.
But Two Ton Tessie, 1, 2, 3.
Yeah,
two ton is already taken.
I'm telling you, CB radio.
You got two more people.
I got three more
Scopo
people.
And Deepu and
three more people.
Stavros. What are you fucking running the show?
I want to hear. I want to hear they see.
It's all right. I didn't have a good answer anyway, so you can skip it.
Chubby Delight.
I don't like it. Do it.
Come
on.
That
sounds
like frozen yogurt. I see why you forgot him.
I want feta tits.
Feta tits. Ooh. That's
wow,
not bad. Not
that's
tits.
The best.
I like feta, though.
Looks like Lizard Bitch has competition.
What do you got?
Scoping the Night.
No.
Ooh. Wow, that's a. He actually did a real one.
He was right.
Yeah.
No, but
he's. What are. I mean, do
that's his
have...
real CB. I guarantee his fucking WAP parents in the basement have a CB radio, and for shits and giggles in the summer, when he was a little kid, they'd just go downstairs, and his was. What was your name again?
Scoping the Night.
Scoping the Night.
Sounds
I
like a
guarantee.
Late night radio.
Wait, you
show
said his WASP parent?
WASPs.
WASP.
Your parents
WASP.
Are WASPs?
Yeah. Wops.
Waspy Wops.
Wop.
The S comes first.
Italian.
Wasp.
No, that's different.
No, that's a different word.
That's white Anglo-Saxon Protestant.
The word he's saying is worse.
Yeah, it's worse.
Yes.
Wasps
are
on CB
very
radio
proud.
Right now.
Wops, not so much.
Wop.
Fucking Wops.
It's Italian.
What does it mean?
It's an Italian.
It's a derogatory term for
like
Italian.
Dago.
Oh, it's like calling.
Spick.
Calling what? No, let him go.
The Italian equivalent.
It's like
speak.
Calling.
Let him go.
It's not my show. Go ahead.
Jason's going all out. Like,
no,
it's like
I'm
same speak. What
it's
else?
Like
is that calling? Is that calling fat people fat motherfucker?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
Close.
Like calling an Italian motherfucker.
Yeah. I know. It's kind of like telling a girl she used to be a fat.
Look, I saw you walking down the street. I'm like, hot damn. And then I know her.
Oh, so much better.
And then
Thank you.
You barely looked at me like, I'm skinny now. Move out
What's
my way.
What's my name?
I can't.
All right, shut up.
What's my name?
Will, bitch.
They've been saying all day.
I actually call him fucking Ashy Hands. Is there any way you could spit on your hands?
He's been woodworking all day.
Jesus Christ, you look like you just built sandcastles. get something on those knuckles. I'm getting thirsty.
That's how it is?
Is that CB radio personality
that
talking.
I'm sorry. That was
going down?
That was Two Ton Tessie. Over.
So I ended up calling Robert, and I said, hey, Robert, it's Keith Malley. He said, hey, how you doing? He's always been nice to me, kind of Keith and the girl in general.
Oh, that's my name, by the way.
And the girl.
It's one of those three. That's all I'm going to say. And so he goes, oh, hey, how's it going? and then I said, so we're going to be at the, this is like a week ago or so.
Yeah.
We're going to be at the, happen to be at the Comedy Cellar. I want to see if you're doing a show. We'd love to talk about the tour on your show, see you again, et cetera. Yeah. And he goes, yeah, okay, all right. And I go, so if you're around doing a show or now between our tour in October, you know, let's see if we can work something out. Yeah, that sounds good. Hold on. And then I'm like, all right, Robert, it's okay. You know, we'll figure this out. He's like, hold on. I'm stuck in fucking traffic. It's a fucking mess. Fuck everything. Fuck. Yeah. And he goes, hold on. I'm going to pull the fuck over. So I go, all right, relax. We'll figure it out. And
what a shit thing to say.
No, but I didn't say like,
no, you
relax.
Did. No, you did. No, you did. First of all, your tone is that.
Thank he doesn't know that, though. It's like you don't know. Unintentional.
Yeah. But I mean, I could tell I'm giving this guy a heart attack. And I'm like, no, whatever the fuck I'm saying isn't worth it.
No.
Relax. Everything will be fine.
That's his delete. Let's start over.
That's the tone that you think you have. But the other tone is what you really have.
So I go,
relax.
Easy, baby boy. Take your will pacifier, I say. And so he goes, hold on, I'm going to pull over. Then he goes, okay.
Yeah.
Now, what tour is this? Who is this? And I go, oh, this is. And he goes, first of all, you don't fucking tell me to relax. Nobody tells me to refund. And what the fuck tour is this? And I go, Robert, it's me, Keith, from Keith and the Girl. And he goes, oh, Keith! I mean,
that's not true.
He goes,
I still kept the fuck you tone.
Oh, right, but
don't fucking say I turned girly.
It was in a different key.
I'm gonna give you. You keep going. I'm gonna give you my tone.
Let's do this.
It was very nice, and it was definitely a different tone. It was like, Keith from Keith and the Girl. Yeah, I would do anything for you. Absolutely.
You're missing a vital fucking part.
You know
you're forgetting a fucking chunk.
You motherfucker. He does say, like, hey, next time don't be so formal. Say, first, hey,
no.
buddy.
No, I didn't.
Bobby, it's Kate, blah, 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 your friend for years now.
That's not true.
What's interesting to me when you tell people before you tell people the truth is that he didn't think this was a good friend. He thought it was some business thing. I mean, he's on TV now. It's not crazy he'd be getting a call about a tour, even if it's, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And he's like, first of all, motherfucker.
Hang on. Now, are you done? You're repeating.
Now I'm done.
You should have told him that you lost weight first.
Here's the
deal. I'll tell you butter about it.
Here's the deal. Ready?
Right.
I'm in late for the show here.
Right.
I just a bunch of crazy shit happened that day.
I have some gas. I woke up too early.
It's just fucked up. My brain is trying to get the fuck over here. I live in traffic. Some crazy shit happened. Now this guy in front of me is telling me to go, and I'm like, "You go." And this big muscle, hard hat, go. Like I annoyed him, and he's like, "Go." And I'm like, you go.
And then he's
like,
you
go. Just go, you fuck. And he goes, you fucking. I went, and I was fucking angry that he fucking got me. I was so mad, because all I had to do was go, no, you go.
Right.
And not, I have a vehicle.
Yep.
You understand? I win. I'm steel. I have steel around me.
I did that this morning to somebody.
Right?
This truck. I was about to cross. It's obviously there right away, and I know that they're trying to get my attention to say that I should cross. And I'm like, I'm not about to walk in front of your truck right now.
No.
And I'm just not looking at them. I believe that they're calling me a bitch for not taking the cross.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, I'm gonna win this one because I'm just gonna.
And you won.
Yeah, I won.
I didn't. I fucking lost. Phone rings.
I'm sorry, humble brag.
Actually, I think I lost. But go on.
So I lose. Now my phone rings. You know, and I really, it's Keith, man. I don't hear any of that.
Right.
I hear Keith, but he introduces him with his last name.
Could have been Keith Rock.
Which is like, but I don't really hear that. I don't hear the last name at all. I just hear Keith Mowling or whatever.
I talk fast.
And then he goes right into we're doing a tour.
He didn't ask you how you doing or how was your day?
No. We're doing a tour. We're in the area.
It's so funny.
We want to come on your show and maybe promote the tour. And now I have people crossing in front of me. I'm taking that right. There's literally all the shit's going on.
He didn't say, are you busy right now?
I have headphones.
No, I know
he didn't say, are you busy right now?
Hang on one second. Let me just finish.
I said relax.
So now I'm fucking, someone had just literally cut in front of me.
Oof.
And then looked at me like, fuck. And I was like, I'm trying to listen to him. I don't know who the fuck this is, but I don't want to say I don't know who it is yet. I'm going to pull on a... And I'm like, okay, I'm just going to pull over and deal with this and find out. I'm getting too confused and overwhelmed here. Let me just fucking pull over. I'm just going to go, who the fuck is this? What's going on? And he goes, hey, relax. Ooh. Right? Hey. He said, hey, first of all. Right? You know,
my name's so bad. I should say buddy, but hey.
He goes, hey, relax. It's like, first, anybody that tells you to relax doesn't want you to relax.
Never.
They want you to go, fuck you.
Right.
Do you understand that?
No. Who would want that?
Hang on one second. Here's the deal. When people say relax, they go, you don't go, the word relax never has relaxed
never
anybody.
Never means relax.
Ever. No one's ever said relax. And your tone stinks. You got to work on your tone. It blows. Okay?
Maybe you do a podcast.
It's very fucking
easy. Easy.
Okay? So then he goes, I go, wait a minute. Who the fuck is this? And he goes, it's Keith from Keith and the Girl. I go, Jesus Christ. Right. What the fuck, dude? I go, what? Just say, what's up, bro? It's Keith. Keith and the Girl. What's happening? How you doing?
How are your kids?
Are you busy right now?
I got a second. Yeah, I go, we're friends. You just talk to me like a telemarketer. I go, you call me up with fucking information and your last name. I go, what the fuck is that?
Who does that?
I go, dude.
I wish everybody did it to me.
I go, listen, you had your fucking time.
Get the
Judge
gavel.
Judy all of a sudden.
Oh, no.
Go gavel. There we go.
That's what cracks
Order
in glass.
The curt.
I hate the show.
Here's the point, right?
Oh, shit.
Yannis, what's up, buddy?
Hey, Yannis.
Where you going?
Yannis is here, man.
That's all right. He can sit down at the end.
Too many Greek people. Get
buddy,
out.
Buddy, he can sit down at the end.
Greek
So we got another mic over here. We're good. So did I? Yeah, I got that fucking mic. Yeah, we're good. So anyways, I go, hey. I go, fucking, dude, we've known each other. Hey, buddy. I go, do it. He goes, hey, I made you do it. I go, hey, say, and you were like, hey, bro. I go, hi, buddy, how are you? Hey, it's me. And it's like, we're friends. Don't talk to me like we're fucking business partners. Like we're, starting an app together, you fuck.
When people say, hey, relax, it's always on some power shit.
Somebody says, hey, relax to you. Is that... to relax you or to fucking control
rile you up? Is
leading
it to rile you up?
Depends
leading
on what you're doing.
I'm fucking.
Depends on what's going on.
Oh, and I don't want to do this, but I'm just going to defend Keith for a minute. First of all,
of course you are.
No, I'm going to say that.
Of course she's the one who brought up the whole fucking relax and got me in trouble just now. now she's on my side.
Well, I think you're right to say that relax usually pisses people off.
And his tone. Remember the tone? You said I was right about that.
And mumbling his last name.
You know what's weird? Yeah. We once had a phone call with, oh my God, who did you piss off like a long time ago? God damn it. There's so many.
Patrice's mom?
No.
That motherfucker's crazy.
What happened was, Keith, you were a huge fan of this person. And
Bobcat Goldthwait?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
He called in. Keith is actually
Loved
a
him.
Huge.
Thought he was a brilliant writer.
Huge
he still
fan.
Is.
Special, yeah.
This is what Keith's tone does to people. He goes, oh, I really loved you and this, that, and the next, and it was really fantastic. And Bobcat goes, are you fucking with me?
Oh.
And sincerely, they got into a thing. And it went into some weird fucking
place. And I was
very
nice. Him being mad at me or not trusting me didn't make me be mad back. It was more just a shame.
So
but
it
yes,
a
it went to a
wait, wait,
so
wait,
you're
wait,
already
wait,
in a hole
wait,
at that
your
point.
Your tone. Oh,
he sounds sarcastic when he's being sincere.
Right. That's a big problem.
And it's like
problem,
the weirdest, weirdest thing.
It really
Imagine
does.
Imagine dating that shit. Like, oh, I love you.
Oh, you look great.
Now we know why.
You're beautiful.
We don't even date men anymore. We know why.
No, I do date men. I married a man.
Really?
He is transgender.
I know, yes.
All right, so
I want to get into that, too.
Oh, all wow.
Let's not go forward. I want to get into that. We're going to get into all this stuff. You guys come into it with a lot of stuff. So you're going on this tour. Let's explain this tour.
By the way, sorry. Are you in anger management or something like this?
I go to fuck. I just can't. I go to.
Take your time. Take your time. Take your time.
I'm not in anger management. I actually go to. I've accept my personality.
Right.
Okay. But I'm also. I accept that I. That's who I am.
Okay.
I kind of snap. But I was right.
You have a bounce back.
I was absolutely right.
Well, I'm not saying you were wrong. Do you happen to go to anger management?
I am going to. Meditation.
Were you
on
at meditation?
Meditation.
Are you trying
just
to
in
you know what that is?
I know what that is.
Were you at meditation that day, coincidentally?
I was not. Okay. I went the next day.
Okay.
How
because
much, of you.
How much bad gadgets you got, man?
What?
I want to do yoga with you.
He doesn't
Imagine
do yoga.
Bobby's down
no, he's
with
going
dog.
To. You want to do yoga
oh,
together?
I do yoga. What are you talking Since about?
Do you really do yoga?
Yes, I do yoga.
Getting out of bed is not yoga.
Ooh, it is for Bobby.
You're a fucking asshole.
Breathe in, fuck
How
you.
How many gadgets you
lamp?
Got, dude?
Relax.
He's got a light.
You pull the gravel out. I got a flashing disco light.
Is that how good you're getting at this now? You can do it while you're setting up the lights at the same time?
This show is...
Are you just lighting Will?
No, I'm lighting Will because Will is so fucking dark. I can't.
It's going everywhere. You gotta light him.
I need to.
Why don't you go? Why don't you get my lamp? My lamp.
I need the other one.
This why
one.
Not had a
why did you light him with police lights? It's blue and red blinking in his face.
Straight out of Compton. Crazy motherfucker from Haiti. Makes a lamp that makes you want to go crazy. He made this fucking lamp for me, Giannis. Giannis Pappas awesome. Is in the
hey,
house.
Hey, Giannis Pappas.
Fucking Flood City King right here.
That was a pleasure to watch. You three just crushing fucking podcast radio right there. Three pros just going at it. I was like, nobody else is going to be able to get a word in. You guys are crushing.
I tell you, me and Keith had a little fucking ram headbutt. But he called me up. But I think now you call me up, you go, what's up, bro? It's Keith.
Yeah.
And then we're good.
Your script.
Yeah, we're good.
All right.
What's up, dude? Yeah, like that. Let's try it again really
quick.
Hey,
you know what,
dude? Let's try it again. I'm going to recreate. Fucking you go. No, you fucking. Hello. Hello.
Hey, buddy. It's me, Keith.
Keith, what's up, buddy?
Whoa. Dude, relax.
He fucked it up.
It made me mad again.
He said, dude, to start himself. Hey,
right, my chest hurts right now.
You get into character.
Well, why you said relax? He was relaxed.
It seemed like he was upset. He sounded wound up.
I fucking hate relax. My wife does that to me. All right, calm down.
Oh, yeah.
Don't tell me to fucking calm down. I have a legitimate... Like, she gets mad. Right. Here's one thing that's been happening with... I'll get mad at something, okay? And I'm like, oh, this motherfucker with the fucking chair.
Ugh. It's a lamp.
And she'll be like, well, it's not my fault. I'm like, it's not your fucking fault. I know it's not your fucking... Can I get mad? Like, I can't get mad anymore. Like, I can't just fucking snap anymore.
Right.
Because if you snap... Everybody's like, relax. Oh, my God.
You know why?
Why?
Right?
Why? Because
you're dangerous.
Because look at you, Bobby. You cannot get mad at least till you lose 10 pounds minimum.
No, fuck that shit. All listen. Right.
Wait a minute. One second. Oh, you got
He's
the
got
bomb.
It.
He's got
Plus,
it.
Plus, it's like when you snap where you live, it's a lot scarier because there's not a lot of people to save her if something goes wrong.
Right.
You're out there.
First of all, what? Mm. First of all, I don't know.
He lives out in the country, so it's like when a husband
well,
snaps.
Well, if you have
like,
to explain it.
It's a little scarier.
Did you find that remote, please? Just go find it.
Bobby, that would be terrifying.
You got to call, like, Westbury police. It takes them 45 minutes to get there.
Because they can't believe someone called them to begin with.
911 is a joke in this town. Also.
It's comedian Bobby Kelly. You know Bobby Kelly from You Know What, Dude?
I think that fucking Giannis gets
He's
black,
breaking
too.
Stuff.
Let me turn down your fucking mic. Jesus Christ. You know these work, right? These are short 58.
I like your new Darth Vader get up there.
This is my fucking...
He does look like a supervillain.
Master and servant.
This is my...
he got a lot of gadgets behind
Just looks like Dr. Evil.
You look like Mini-Me.
I'll shave my head and sit on your lap.
Actually, you look like fat Mini-Me.
Okay, let's try again real quick.
Not so Mini-Me.
Bobby, three okay, quarters.
All right, hang on one second. What's
you're
that?
Stuck in traffic.
Yes.
All right. Ring.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Again?
Go. Hello. Hello. What's up?
Hey, it's me, Keith. Take out the garbage.
I'm sorry. What the fuck did you say to me? You
hey,
fucking
relax.
Cocksucker.
Cocksucker.
Hey, I'm sorry, man. I apologize. What do you mean by take out the garbage? I don't.
Is this a three-way call?
All right. I want you to do it between you and Giannis.
Yeah, do it.
Giannis. Now, Giannis, here's your scenario.
Yeah.
You just got fucking, you've been in traffic, you're late, two accidents coming down here. Now you're going to take a right, and some guy with a hard hat and a fucking, you know, T-shirt is going, you go. And you're like,
t-shirt.
No, you go. And he's like, just go. And you're
right.
Like,
you're,
just,
you're
you go.
Car, he's
and
out
then,
in the street.
Will, shut up. He's going, right? And I go, you go. And then he goes, no, just fucking go, asshole. And then I go, and the alpha mailed me, and now I'm like pissed. Now I'm taking a right. The phone rings.
Dude,
I'm pissed. I'm late. Now you
okay.
go. Brrr, let me do the. Can I please?
Oh, he's on the phone.
I'm going to go. My ringer's different than that, okay?
Doing Hold down, up. I got to get into character here.
Character.
Officially improv. I got improv skills. Hold on. Let me drive for a little bit.
Okay. This is one of your AOL skits. Relax, all right? Jesus Christ. Fucking thespian.
All right.
Give him a fucking internet show. He turns into fucking Pacino.
I need a ring. I can't work without a ring. All
right. I'm going to give you the ring. Ready? Okay. Ready? Bing bap boom bop ba dee da ba ba boom bop bop. Bing bap boom bop da dee da.
Hello? God damn, hello?
Hey Yannis, it's Keith. How you doing, buddy?
Oh, what's up, Keith? How you doing, man?
Good.
Damn it. Yeah.
You sound like you got some shit going on.
I'm driving fucking New York City, man. This guy, it's a whole thing, man. How you doing,
it's
man?
It's the worst. Should I catch you another time?
No, I'm good. I'm good.
No. Fuck
he's
it.
Just being so just pleasant now.
Step down. Wait. No, go back. Wait, telemarketer, Keith.
I see.
Holy shit. Dynamics
understood. Okay, I'm ready. I'm ready. Call right. him again, Bobby, please.
Yeah. I want telemarketer, Keith.
Okay. Right.
I want fucking the scenario that happened.
Okay.
All right? And I want cunty tone at the beginning.
I got it.
All right, here we go. Ready? All right, ready?
It's a very big steering wheel, Yannis.
Here we go. Ready?
This car gets better and better.
Five, four,
he's driving a bus.
Three, two, one.
Hello?
Oh, fuck. Mr. Pappas.
Yeah.
This is Mr. Malley.
Who?
How have you been? You know me.
Who? Mr. Malley?
Hey, I'm going on tour.
Yeah.
Now it's part of your life.
Come on, man. Who is this?
Here's what I need you to do. No. Easy, baby. Poppy, easy.
Who is this, man?
I'm your friend, Keith.
God
calm
damn.
Down.
Oh, take the out worst the improv. Dog.
Jesus. Fuck. I'm just going through some shit right now.
Right. You know what's cool is that you're a normal human being. With me being such an asshole, you still controlled yourself. Anyway, I'll see you at your show tonight. Goodbye,
Clay. And I was bullshit. Real. That was my that was
that
my real.
Fuck you and fuck you.
I put myself in that place. Yeah.
You fucking two goddamn
doing
Chicago
with
fucking.
Doing with Jason.
You guys
what
are fucking.
UCB.
I think we've got it.
Had you seen
Bobby?
Had
you seen him before the conversation?
We've got enough shitty improv.
There's too many fucking people. You're talking over each other. Settle down, all right?
Calm down.
Yeah, calm down.
Relax.
Calm down. All right? That's bullshit. I call bullshit. But I'm going to move on. I'm going to move on. I was in. Here you go, Keith. Here you go. Here you go, Keith.
Ooh,
you and my wife can have as much as you want. You ready? Yeah. Oh. I'm sorry for snapping.
That's all you had to say.
That was so sincere.
You just made me angrier. You accepted my apology. No,
You're supposed to say no, thank you.
Yeah.
I'm very sorry for snapping. I'm sorry for snapping on you, Deepu.
Oh, thank you.
I'm sorry for snapping on you.
Makes it angry.
I'm sorry
apology
for snapping on you.
Fuck you.
I'm sorry for snapping on you.
And say sorry to
the lamp.
I'm sorry to your lamp. Is it art lamp. Or lamp?
Art lamp.
Let me apologize
lamp art.
For not accepting your lamp art as graciously
that
as I should
like
have.
It tasted good.
Yannis, I'm sorry for ever snapping at you, if I ever do.
Am I
Scopo?
The only one?
Yeah. This is a big one. This is a big one.
Chemda, I'm sorry for snapping at you. I've
Scopo's
never done
the,
that, but I'm sorry.
In the waiting room, I appreciate it.
And Scopo, I'm sorry for snapping at you every day for the last month and a half.
Longer than that.
If I could speak for everybody, we didn't even notice.
Oh, good. I don't like to be told to relax. I really hate it. So anyways, they're going on this great tour, which now has this ever been done? A podcast go on tour? Is this original? Are you breaking new ground? Am I going to do this? Is everybody going to do this now?
I think everyone should do it.
People do.
So everyone could go crazy like we are. No, I think, other podcasts, there is definitely another podcast. I'm so annoyed that the name isn't coming to mind, but I don't think they did the tour bus. Mm-hmm. So I think they did like from city to city, but
right.
I don't know how they traveled. So that like. Is one difference.
When does it start?
October 9th through the 18th. KeithandTheGirl.com/tour is where you could find all the dates. Ooh. And tickets.
Give that one more time.
KeithandTheGirl.com/tour.
Okay, great. And
T-O-U-R.
And you can buy tickets. Can how much are the tickets?
They vary.
Oh, good.
They start at $21.50.
And they go up from there. So you get a VIP package or a better seats and stuff like that.
I mean, we try to get people to get their tickets. So there's like early bird, medium bird, and late bird.
Oh, okay.
Medium bird.
Right.
And then
I'm hungry, by the way.
There's hamburger, cheeseburger, french fries.
How are the birds prepared?
Right. If you're into going, you know, do us all the favor and get tickets ahead of time.
Can I say something, too, about the ticket buying with these people? You know, people who are listening right now or you know.
They make you sweat.
It's really, it really is. It's like, I just did I'm doing that JFL thing And right. it, you know, and I and every week I do shows, and they make you sweat it out.
Yeah.
And you know,
like they know they're coming, but they're like, "Oh, I'll get the tickets next week."
All you have to do is make a fucking phone call. Just get
a
the
phone
number.
Call. No, what is
or let me. I know. Or go. Or go online. Right. But you can literally just go online, get a phone call, talk to a human being. I want tickets, or fill out the form right. in less than 5 minutes. Have your tickets, and save us the fucking dread.
I would
of having to get a club owner go. Can you push it a little harder on Twitter? Because we've only sold. Oh.
And there's not. And there's also not one show we haven't done where people tell us, "Oh, I can't believe I missed out that day. I didn't."
I fucking hate that.
It's like,
I'm sorry. Let me bring
all
it down.
Could have been more comfortable. Down. Easy. Somebody else
relax,
say it.
Relax, man.
Somebody else say it, not me. Thank you.
But I haven't done one show where it's been the. You know, you get these fuck. And then, hey, when are you coming to town? I motherfucker, yeah. I was just fucking in, you motherfucker.
Yeah.
How dare you fucking tweet me that? How dare you tweet me when I'm coming back to Utah? I was just there trying to sell tickets.
And now I'm stuck in traffic. Fuck you.
Anyways, what's that?
Will has two phones. It's me, Will. I want to ask you a question.
It's Keith from Keith and the Girl.
I got to go,
man. Are you
man.
Selling lamps?
Where are you going?
I got things to do, man. I got my tour bus outside.
Where
I'm starting
in
Mexico.
You?
Then we're going to go to Dallas.
Is Wally driving you?
Wally.
Wally's the best.
Wally.
You should get the best.
Wally's the best.
Well, I want you to, before you go, I want you, we're going to. We'll
take the lamp?
hold on. He's reaching back in his gadget cave.
Where's all my Sharpies?
In your butt?
Hanky sheep. Hanky sheep. Give it a hanky sheep.
I want a black one. Where's the black Sharpie?
I give. No, you keep it, Will.
No, you keep it.
You ain't going to give it a hanky sheep?
That wasn't bad.
Why don't we put the hanky sheep over the lamp?
Is there a shitty lamp bandana that we can give you?
It's literally. Have you seen that he made that?
No.
You make that with your hands?
Yeah, I made with my damn hands.
That one? That lamp that he brought it in tonight, man.
I make things with my hands all the time. Yeah, handmade. Should I say handmade? Yeah. I don't know the proper thing before I get attacked about my English. Handmade,
your
made
English?
With my hands.
Handmade.
Yeah, both. You could use both.
That's the word you picked on.
Attack. I think attack about my English would be the part we'd attack. Not the handmade or the handmade with my hands.
Where you attack a burger?
No, that was pretty good. I'll fucking give it to you.
I do like burgers.
I love a burger. Respect.
You do have a sarcastic way of talking.
See? Thank you. I take back my apology. I take it back. I'm right, right? It's a weird. And yeah, Hemda, you know.
I know whose side he was on.
Well, you're all very smart to have that opinion.
what a cunty way. All right, well, thank you, man. It's a beautiful thing. I want you to sign it, but I want it with a black Sharpie. Maybe you should sign it with silver. Everybody else signed it with black.
That's a great idea.
All right, now I want you to sign it right in a nice spot in the center.
Sign it to
somewhere
me.
Where your name sticks out, but not too big. No, I'm kidding. Sign it somewhere, please. Thank you, Will. Can we get this on video, please?
Hold on.
Did you find a Sharpie?
This video?
Nice.
All right. What's that?
We're going to do video.
He put on his sunglasses.
It's
fucking, oh, my God.
Yeah.
It's 10:20. Not there. In the middle.
It's,
like.
You can turn it any way.
Watch it down the bottom. Ooh. Down the bottom.
Bottom.
Right, you know.
I feel like I'm at a Hard Rock Hotel right now.
Right down a little further, so, you know, right in case nobody else wants to sign it, it still looks like a lamp.
Right here?
Yeah, that's right in the middle, though. In the
that's
middle.
A lamp?
Looks like a right fucking.
In the middle.
It's
in
like
the
a
middle.
Blood
that's the middle. Down. Down.
This is the first time anyone's
right there,
asked
right
Will
there,
to sign
right
anything.
There. This is like right there. And just sign your
right
name.
Right there. Just right there. Yep. More in the middle. Mm-hmm.
Is that the shape mm-hmm. of the Grammys? Is that what they look like?
I don't know. That's the Grammys in around 30,000 years.
Right there.
That's great, man.
A little slower.
Perfect. Hey.
That's great.
A little bigger, a little wider.
Unbelievable, buddy.
Looks
thank
like the bad
you.
Guy in a sci-fi movie.
Will, I love you, buddy. Thank you for coming up, and thank you for the gift.
See you, Will.
In a year from now, we're going to raise around $16, baby. All right? We're going to get some ramen noodles for those little kids in tents.
Delicious.
Kids in tents.
All right,
eating
buddy.
Ramen.
I love you, kid. Take it. What the fuck?
That was funny.
You can't just
it was good. That was good.
He's
that was
got the gavel.
I got laughs. I'll see you later, buddy.
Leave it on his mic.
Willie, I'll see you, buddy.
Do you want to?
Yeah, sit over here. Yeah, oh, yeah, sit over here because it's a better shot. Anyways, Wow, that was fucking great. Holy shit. That I mean, now I like it.
It is kind of cool, actually.
It grew on me.
It is kind of cool. And it does match.
I loved it the whole time.
Where does the light bulb on it?
The light's on the bottom.
On the bottom. Yeah.
So it's a lamp if you're going to do blow off a hooker in 1988. If it's a very disco-y, you know. Yeah, modern art type of lamp.
It's more like a room obstruction with a little light at the bottom.
It looks like somebody taped glow sticks to it.
Like, I don't have that much room up here, and it really does take up a lot of space.
It's like you finished making it, went, oh, it's meant to be a lamp. Yeah. Shit.
I'd rather it be the other way, like upside down. Like right. If there was some type of stand on the other pointy end. But if somebody does ever piss me off outside, I can throw that on them. So if dinosaurs ever come back, maybe I'll kill one with it.
If he tells you to relax again, you got something.
I'm
going to
fucking smash it over his head. No,
he carried that up here?
He
today?
Did.
He had help, right?
That's why he was coming up to me and coming up. That's why he was coming up going, we were wondering before the show, like Will was like, am I on, I'm on the show? And I was like, no, I don't think, I didn't want to say you're not because you can come up if you really want to, but. Because he, you know, he's one of the guys that can literally just stop by if he wants. Right.
But I don't think I recall this ever.
Fucking weird, man. Yeah. That was weird. Then he just showed up with the lamp. What a sweet guy.
That is
sweet.
Look at him lighting you now. This is you're the distance.
Yeah, and he changed it to yellow. It's not the police colors anymore.
Well, I had white on Will. I had to really brighten him up.
Look at these Greek bookends we have.
That's
here.
Right.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyways. We showed the video of the girl hitting the lady with the dog. Have you seen that?
Yeah, it's brutal. I hate that, man. But I watched it.
It's
impossible to scroll over one of them and not watch it. But don't you have to assume that because she's a bitch, that the dog really is an asshole because that's how she raised the dog. So if that makes you feel any better, fuck
people like that aren't raising a nice dog.
That's a good point, man. I mean, it looked like it worked, though. Like, she hit him, and then, like, the fight was over.
I'm pretty sure that'll work every time.
Yeah. You get hit by a fucking tail. That freaks you out when something hairy hits your face. Like, this bitch just hit me with a hairy fucking fist. Yeah. Oh, it's her dog. This bitch is crazy. She walked away like it was a fucking purse.
Yeah,
crazy. What about the VMAs the other night? That was fucking
nuts. Did you see
it happen?
I didn't
even know what was going on.
I don't know what
was
going on.
That's how adult I am.
Yeah. I just like, it's so weird that they still do it. They like run reruns of Ridiculousness.
Right. Well, there are new kids now. It's not for you, right?
It's when people are still fucking. Yeah. It's like, they're still babies.
It's weird. It's weird what they do. They let fucking Kanye just run.
For 10
and
minutes.
I don't think he gets it anymore that they're just letting him be fucking moronic.
No, he's the best.
So
to
for,
get
I don't
think he cares.
Think,
I love Kanye.
I don't think he gets it. I think he buys into it.
What?
I don't think he realizes that. You think that he realizes that MTV knows he's out of his fucking mind?
Yes. Yeah, 100%.
I think they know. I think he's comfortable with the amount of out of his mind people think he is because he's getting shit done and living his life.
Because that gets
he's completely sincere the whole time. He's the best.
Yeah.
I think you're getting your hair until I hear you a little soft,
that's so
great
nice
voice.
To say.
Do you think you can have a one-on-one with Kanye and be like, I got to tell the world, he's fucking brilliant.
He is brilliant. He's fucking the best.
He's brilliant in a lot of ways.
Wow. And he's very inspirational.
In what way? I mean, his rap, no joke, I think every album is fucking genius. And he has four, and there hasn't been a fucking bummer yet.
That's
and
a lot.
I don't even mean by hits. I mean,
right.
I love it. So, but
the important things.
But the point is, other than that, though, I can't imagine having a conversation with him. You think so?
Can you imagine that he changed
his
genre?
You guys are insane.
By being in it?
Never
absolutely.
Mind that.
Absolutely.
He changed a genre 808s by being
and,
in it.
808s and Heartbreaks is like, that's what all of music is now. That's like, everyone's shitting on him for doing auto-tune and doing like sappy shit and like broken-hearted shit. But what's Drake doing now? That's what mainstream rap is now.
He changed the way people dress. He changed the way they do beats.
Well,
he
tried
the
to change
rap.
The way people dress. I think he lost like $8 million trying to do that.
Yeah.
But what's his mixtape like, though?
His albums are great. And his mixtapes aren't
battle
bad.
Rap about, though? What's the street
can't
saying?
Battle.
That's just always like, whenever you have a black friend, they start saying that to you. Like, I have no idea what you're talking. I didn't even know there were mixtapes.
Can I just say something, though? He has hints of true honesty in the weird shit
absolutely.
That he says.
He's completely sincere.
All right, let me finish, all right? I know you're fucking jacking off fucking
Kanye. I love
Kanye.
Him. He's the best.
I know you do. I get it. But I'm saying, I'm not a big fan of his music. Maybe it's just a generation thing. I'm not a fan. I'm not like, fuck him. But he does have these little weird moments where you're like, Am I fucking right. losing my mind? Because he just made sense.
But right.
Like this
yeah,
fucking
then
lunatic
he says he's
just
for
made
president.
Me go, I vote for him. Like, yeah. Yeah,
I was going to say to you, do you ever listen to crazy people and then you're like, wait, that makes so much sense?
Yeah.
I fucking just her fucking spent an hour with your fucking boyfriend over here.
Oh, that's my ex. And he's going to, yeah, it's been years and we're very adamant about that.
do you guys ever it's have an old moment where like there's
like,
oh,
I still remember. It's hard because I still remember when she was a fat mess and I can't.
But like, very lovable.
You guys still do it every day, right?
Yeah.
There's got to be a day where it goes through your head during
I totally get what you're saying, yeah. But we really hate each other.
If it wasn't
it's really not.
If
there,
it wasn't no me, joke. He would agree with you, and he'd right. be like, "Yeah, of course, it runs through my mind." But he's right. like, "No, she's a bitch. How am I saying? She's sitting right
you guys
next
really
to
not get together? I mean,
really?
get along."
Oh, we get along. Oh, we get along. Of yeah. course, we get along. Every day.
I mean, you
yeah,
guys like,
have
do you
along.
Love each other? Do your family? Are you getting along? Are you getting along like Bob and Tom?
I don't.
You know what I mean? Like right. for the show.
I think we get frustrated with each other.
We get frustrated with each other. We happened to just hang out the other day.
Oh yeah.
So much regret in her voice. Ugh,
who's
yeah.
got tone now? Maybe I'm on your side, Keith.
But I think that what one of the greatest things is we learned how to argue, which sounds really, you know.
No, I get that.
Yeah, shit, so
I wish me and him could learn how to argue. Fucking relax.
Well, he used to get really nervous when I got upset or crying or like yeah. even like with a, you know, stern tone. And now I'm just like, I'm going to be angry for a while. And you're going to then tell me your point of view, and you could be as angry as I am.
Right.
And then we're going to get through it. And then the end, and I'll see you fucking tomorrow on air. Who gives a shit? If I can't say this shit to you, yeah. I can't be around you.
That's why you make a good point.
When you
have an argument with a friend, and all of a sudden, that's why I hate when people will bring in really unfair shit to an argument,
right.
like some really holy shit weapon.
Like
that they've
been
holding
it.
On, and it's like, dude, this is just an argument. We're gonna this. Mm. Let's have this fight. Don't make this about something it's not. Don't fucking end this friendship.
Yeah.
Because let's just. I agree with you. Like, but sometimes people bring in shit. Well, what about the time that you? It's like, whoa,
If it's not relevant, yeah. I don't want to hear about it. I'm gonna shut you down. If it's relevant and it's in the past and it's repeating itself, okay. I get to bring it up right, because.
Hang on, I'm not Keith.
I'm like
and that time.
Guys, relax.
Hey, don't fucking tell us to relax.
Don't tell an Israeli to relax.
Never tell a fucking Israeli to
relax.
Relax. We don't even know what it is.
Well, I watched these MTV things the other night. I did watch Miley and.
She's the best. Talking
cool
about the
guy.
Best.
You great love guy. Her.
She's just so ridiculous that you have to stop thinking about what ridiculous is and go with it. She's just like, then what? I'm coming out like this. What are you going to say about
she
it?
She does some racist shit, though. I don't know. She called Snoop Dogg her mammy on the fucking VMAs. And her whole tour before, I mean, the twerking shit, all the cultural appropriation that she does.
Right.
She does a lot of racist shit. I mean, I like what she's doing. Like,
holy shit.
Oh, now we can't twerk.
How old are you?
26.
Oh, that's that millennial shit.
Well,
that's
the cultural right. appropriation.
Is it?
Cultural appropriation.
But, you know, she's like, she's
gender normative.
Her dad
fuck.
Was Achy Breaky Heart. Her dad was the guy who wrote Achy Breaky Heart.
You don't want people judging you by your dad, and that's that.
But no, but what I'm saying is, that's dead. Where she comes from culturally. No, he's alive. Soon.
I didn't do it.
No, but hang on one second. First of all, I was very proud of my little boy when you said that that sentence. And then I was very happy that he snapped me out of it. My friend Yannis went, oh, yeah, you fucking...
Self-hating Greeks, that's what that is. That's tearing each other down.
I thought you guys are dueling Greeks.
Yeah,
that's
right.
Dueling Greeks.
Like
yeah.
dueling characters.
Yeah.
No, you can't do it.
Now you do any character and you win all the money.
Yeah.
No, dude, young people they got this language, man. Just
yeah.
like, yeah, this
cultural appropriation is not that
no,
fucking
but it's
crazy.
All these,
English,
it's all,
Giannis, you Greek fuck.
No,
no, it's this whole it's thing these, where they care for things.
Yeah, it's like, but it's not genuine. Yeah. It's like, it's
no,
like,
it's wait, you're saying I'm not genuine?
You
about
really
that?
Care.
I do care.
You sit
I
up at night
fucked.
And you're like, this is fucking.
Why does he have to sit up at night?
Is,
no,
or
but it fucking annoys me. It annoys me that she just.
Wake up.
Yeah, at about 1 p.m., when I get out of my weed haze.
I like my.
Are you ever really angry about it?
Yeah, I mean, it makes me upset. Yeah, I mean, I'm
have
not
you ever
fucking...
been angry about it after you ate?
after I eat. I'm not angry about much after I eat. I'm kind
By
of in a nice zen state.
What kind of t-shirt is that to wear while you talk about cultural appropriation?
Boom!
Well, I can't.
You got two black guys on your shirt.
That's not what cultural appropriation is.
Michael Jordan holding up Spike Lee by the hair. There's something wrong with it. I don't like
that. That's actually Woody Allen, isn't it?
Woody Allen and Black.
I really did not expect him to say boom. It was just a joke, but the fact that he's taking it seriously.
Yeah, well,
I don't hate Miley Cyrus because she's culturally appropriate.
But it's fucked,
she's
dude.
Fucking,
what? Spit it out.
Trashy and like her music's like poppy, you know.
But when she's not doing the, and I don't get why twerking's insensitive. I guess, don't teach me. I don't want to.
Yeah,
know.
Okay, great.
But when she's being so fucking ridiculous, it's like, oh, something stupid is finally happening. Now, never mind. This show's for children. I don't know why you're watching it, Bobby. But
I'll tell you why I was watching it.
To stay relevant.
It was all over the internet. I turned my TV on to watch our Ray Donovan, me and my wife.
Okay.
And it was just on. It was on the thing. And my friend Joe went, did you just see what the fuck or something on? Right. And I put it on. It was Kanye. It was this guy. Let me see what this fucking guy's saying. Because I do watch that fucking lunatic when he's on fucking stage. And I listened to it, and I was like, I don't fucking hate Kanye. I'm not going to be like, that fucking idiot.
Right.
I think that's ignorant. And I like Miley. Whatever. I don't think she's a fucking...
I like anything different.
I do. I like different stuff. And I like Miley actually brought a bunch of trans women on stage, correct?
There you go.
I don't know. I heard she got the... from what's that show? From Drag Race, right?
Drag Race.
Those are not necessarily trans people.
Okay, now explain.
They're cross-dressers. Some of them are trans people.
One of them was trans.
You gotta learn.
One of them was definitely trans.
I saw. Trust me.
No, because she was wearing a singlet, and she was definitely a guy, but she had no dick there, so she had to be a fucking trans.
How do you know it wasn't?
Because she was wearing a singlet. I
told you.
Scopo was a gender studies major.
Sometimes they tuck.
Dude, I went to Queens College. One thing we did when we were in the fucking backyard smoking cigarettes, we had these discussions. What the fuck, Scopo?
It's insightful.
Mm-hmm. And now he stares at me with that blank fucking stare.
Like ask him about baseball.
No, he's fucking Spider. No. He's fucking Spidering. You said get me a drink, Spider. No, I didn't.
Quick, ask him about baseball.
What do you
Quick.
Want me to say?
Huh?
What do you want me to say?
I'm going to shoot you like fucking, what's his name, in Goodfellas.
I have to watch that movie.
Seen Goodfellas?
He's definitely Spider. Yeah. Today he is.
Do you leave Chris going like, goddamn, I'd like the opportunity, but fuck this show. What am I, the new Baba Booey? Fuck this.
He's got a Bobby Voodoo doll. He just
like it's
puts
not.
Pins in.
Do you? How often do you go home? And go. It's not fucking worth it, Bobby.
Hey, why don't you stop? This is who you're doing. You're sabotaging your own fucking show.
This
all right.
This is why our show's working out. I just go podcast to podcast. Yep.
Destroying everyone.
All right, you leave my fucking Scopo alone. All right. And don't look at Deepu at all. All right? I'm sure your people hate you too.
It's weird that they don't even. You can't even look behind the computer screen. He doesn't respect you.
Scopo, answer the question. Do you want to leave?
No, not at all.
Do you love me?
Yeah.
Do you look at me and say it?
Yeah.
I didn't believe it.
Say
it.
I
love you.
This
bro.
Is some pimp shit.
It's called.
Do you love doing the show?
Yes, I love doing it.
I'll give you $5 if you tell Bobby to relax.
Make it 20. Right?
I'll give you 400 if you beat the shit out of me.
I'll bet 400 against it.
What are you, a Brazilian jiu-jitsu guy? Jesus Christ.
And that's the day we broke up. No karate, sweetheart.
you fucking assholes. Here's the thing. I say they have trans women on, right? You say... Maybe one of them was.
No, I said I don't know that all of them are trans.
But why would you?
Cross-dressers and trans is different.
But aren't they in the same arena? No. Oh, but I'm asking. Okay, I don't know. But aren't they in the same as far as fighting for rights, trying to get equality? I mean, do you want one to get it more than the other?
No, because Eddie Izzard is like a cross-dresser.
Right.
Yeah.
It'd be like saying, aren't they all in the same category as gay? They want rights.
But
it's not just that,
how do you
like they're minorities. Sure, we want everybody to get all the equal rights. In, you know.
But how do you know where that guy is?
You like, ask.
But how do you know, like, oh, there's a guy? Are you making that judgment by physicality? Or do you know that these people are actually just a guy who cross-dresses?
You know, and if you pay attention, people refer to themselves and to each other as the pronoun or the, you know, names that they want to be called. Some cross-dressers want to be called she only when they are in costume. Some of them are called she sort of like for funsies outside of costume. I know that it sounds
I
like
love for funsies, by the way.
I don't have time it's for all, funsies.
Don't people get to choose how they identify, though? Isn't that what? Isn't it how they choose to identify?
Oh, don't be such a millennial.
No, I'm trying to ask. I'm trying to ask.
It'd be funny if the answer was no. Yeah. You guys have pencils? Is number two okay?
But, I mean, it's kind of up to them, right? Like, a cross-dresser could identify as a trans woman.
Yeah, of course.
If they wanted to.
But then they wouldn't. I don't know that they would consider themselves cross-dressers.
They would consider themselves cross-dressers
when they dress as their sex,
but not
their gender. So, okay, sex and gender is different.
Yes.
Your sex is your outside appearance, and your gender is what's happening in your brain.
That's right.
And you can actually mismatch gender and sex.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So once you know that, I feel like you can just apply that to other things.
And speaking of that,
yes.
Your season-long fantasy football team may be going strong.
Seamless.
But you don't have to
what
wait.
Sex you think you are.
You can do it. You don't have to wait. It doesn't matter what you are. You don't have to wait till week 16 to get paid.
Don't
put your
wait.
Fantasy skills. To the test every week this season at DraftKings.com.
Don't go to the regular drafts. Go to the king of drafts.
DraftKings.com, America's favorite one-week fantasy football site. One-week fantasy football means what?
Your biggest fantasy come true.
No season-long commitments also.
No commitment.
You got an injury? What are you going to do?
Oh, you're going to fix that shit right up.
No problem. It's like a new season every week, so you're never stuck with the same players.
Oh, no. You don't want to be stuck with the same thing over and over again.
And get this, Chemda.
What do I get?
DraftKings is crowning a new...
Oh, my God, I'm crowning.
A new millionaire every week this season.
I want to be a millionaire. Tell me more.
You could turn your
love
of football... into a life-changing payday, baby.
I'm ready.
Just pick your players,
mm-hmm.
pile up the points.
Oh, my God.
And pick up your cash.
I'm there.
That's it, boo.
There's got to be more.
Believe me, you've never experienced football like this before.
I feel like I've never experienced this before.
This isn't your fantasy as usual. This is DraftKings.
Unbelievable fantasy, the new millennial of fantasy.
Welcome to the big time, baby.
Oh, my God.
You know what I want you to do?
Everything.
I want you to hurry up to DraftKings.com now and use promo code...
Why?
No.
Oh.
Kelly. To play for free for a shot at $1 million.
Just for the record, there was a Y in Kelly.
In this week's... Millionaire Maker event. Enter Kelly.
K-E-L-L-Y.
For free. Enter now. Only at DraftKings.com. DraftKings.com. That's
DraftKings.com. Don't wait and be a shithead.
I went back. All right. Let's go to the chat room real quick. See what they're saying. What do we got?
Keith Caramello says, Keith Malley looks like an assistant manager to every grocery store.
that's pretty good.
Keith why that's not true.
With an attitude.
Here's your camera right here.
First of all, this other Keith, relax.
See how it came out? That's how it came out with me.
Said fuck you, by the way.
I have never had a job and then wanted to leave and thought of another job. So my point is, whenever my job ended, I was in dire straits, whatever job I had, usually a waiter job that I'm thinking of.
Uh-huh.
I would go to a grocery store and I'm like, I'll take any job. I'll be a 27-year-old deli guy. I'll do whatever. I come in with a resume. I don't know if that turns them off. If you're supposed to just stare at them until they give you a job.
No.
I couldn't be hired as an assistant manager.
Maybe because you're so sarcastic.
Did you tell
the interviewer to relax?
I said it's great to be here.
I literally. stop listening to you 4 minutes ago.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Just because you're not qualified right for the job doesn't mean you don't look like you have it.
Well, I just want to explain.
What else do we got in there?
The Knife Song says, I buy my Bobby Kelly tickets at the last minute, so I know he'll work for it.
Oh, you bitch.
Oh, wow.
What a cocksucker, and he's right.
Fuck the Knife
I will
song.
Fucking work for that fucking $15.
And he loves the shit out of you. These are your favorite fans.
Toronto, September something. JFL 42. Make sure you go to the tickets. Get those. Go ahead.
Buddy C. Buddy says, Will's CB radio name would be Ashy Madison.
That's funny.
That was pretty good.
Yeah, pretty good.
I wish you fucking read that 8 hours ago. I'm going to talk about trans people right now.
And here's a joke from last week.
Yeah, remember the guy? God, what else you got?
That's all I have. Much more of that. Lamp jokes. So, you know.
Give me one lamp joke.
fuck your lamp.
Mookie Phillips says, this is the first time a black person made a pyramid that held together.
Oh. You're still there? What is
Jesus
that?
Jesus Christ. That doesn't even make sense, but I like it. I don't know why. all right, so I want to talk about
that at all.
It wasn't good.
It was.
Why did you laugh so hard?
I think it was because it was. I think it was Egyptian joke. Black.
Yeah, I think he pictured
but
a brown
it doesn't
person.
Make sense because they
held together pretty good.
Really
I know,
good.
But they fell apart a little bit.
I mean, yeah, it's been thousands of
years.
They're actually revered and work like because of how much they've stayed together.
Who's talking like a millennium now?
Yeah. Also, it's millennial.
Yeah, whatever. Millennium.
I think that's racist.
I would know.
I mean, it's the opposite. Like
fucking cunt millennial
together.
Just corrected me. You know what? I was trying to fucking
actually.
actually, there's a normative term for that.
Why did my brain just think there was somebody else here that just left? I was just like looking around like, isn't this somebody else?
this is a real show.
I am. It's funny.
This desk says it is.
It is. It looks real.
Now, you're married to a. Now, this is the thing I want to get to. Because you're married to a man.
Yes.
He was waiting for it. He's been waiting there for the last hour.
I didn't invite him to the wedding. He just found out I was married.
Shocking.
We don't talk that often.
Giannis, it probably won't work out.
Keith, you're still not picturing me naked?
Keith,
no?
The funniest fake, the fake spit take. Fucking is the best. God damn it. Mom. So thank you for faking it, too. I don't want to ruin my new cameras. But now... How do I approach? I don't want to offend you, but it's she was a woman.
Nope.
No, she was never a woman. She physically. How do you approach this? You have to make it make sense for guys or people who don't understand it. Okay. You understand it. You live it. You know what to say. You know what the right
but
thing
I
is.
But I transitioned into this. I did not know all of this information.
Right. So
transition
us.
Are. Okay. So like I said, sex and gender don't match.
Right.
So Lauren was born in the body that he is still in. He never transitioned physically.
Right.
But recognized that he was trans, so he is what is called a trans male.
Right.
So when you look at this person, because he didn't transition, he is in a body that you're not used to men having. But we're trying to make people recognize that men also do come in that body.
Right.
So it's difficult to call it a female body because now we're being proven that a lot of men come in that body and a lot of female come in the opposite body.
Okay, so let me get this straight. It's the having a vagina doesn't make you a woman.
Right.
Having a penis doesn't make you a man.
Exactly.
What's inside of you, who you believe you are, is what makes you the gender, right?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Okay, so the body itself.
They don't feel a real connection. Like my husband doesn't feel a huge connection to his body. He's got phantom penis.
Yeah.
Which is like, it happens like for phantom limb people as well. They feel like it's there.
Lauren always thought his penis would grow in, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm still waiting for it too. I want to see that Aussie dick. I know. I want to know what it look like. I draw that. So, okay. Because it is. Okay.
You can ask, but don't be scared.
I'm not scared at all. That's why I'm excited to be able to have these questions. You know, I'm friends with I'm friends with trans, even more than Bailey.
You're friends with anybody. You're friends with anybody who will be friends with you.
Well, I'm not desperate. Hey, Jesus Christ.
Well, no, I mean, if you're a friendly person, yeah.
You're a needy fuck.
Relax.
And you're still friends with Keith, for fuck's sake.
Jesus. Take it easy.
So
that was aggressive. Wasn't that aggressive?
A little aggressive.
Yeah.
I love
calm
that
Greek man
love,
either side.
I love that Giannis is kind of putting little fucking Stavros in his place. I love it.
How does that put me in my place? This is trying to support my
Stavros, by the way,
name.
One of the best Greek names in it existence. Is.
Thank you.
Oh,
yeah,
my God.
It.
Stavros. Yeah. Stavros.
In comedy.
Other than Gus.
You know, it's way
Gus?
Better.
Stavros. You think Gus is better than Stavros? That's a Greek name.
Fucking way better than Giannis.
Yeah. Well, it's Yannis. We know Yannis. It's Yannis.
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 Yannis is the old Yannis. Man who Yannis. Sits in the old Greek cafe with the other old men sipping espresso and going,
espresso. It'll fix itself, the economy.
Yeah, with
whatever.
Cups that don't have handles,
yeah,
like just with the two fingers.
We have little handles.
I wish you were here today. We did the other show. We were talking about who would you fuck as comics. And you'd be on my list.
Jesus, you're really throwing out a lot of
compliments.
What's the proper term?
Homo
erotic.
But is that okay?
Homo erotic overtone.
Check with the bloggers. Can we check with the bloggers?
Like men in.
We were actually today. We were talking about what comic, if you had to fuck a guy comic, who would you fuck?
Who did you say?
You said Lil Kev.
I said Lil Kev. Because he'd fuck me. Like, he would just weed fuck.
Colin Kane. I'd fuck Colin Kane.
Oh, Colin Kane's that's good, too. I mean, I don't know him, but I've seen him physically.
It's delicious.
Like, some people were picking, like...
Yanni had that locked and loaded.
They're famous. they're famous, you know, their idol. But it's like, fuck off.
Or Bobby. It would be fucking hilarious to fuck Bobby.
Me?
Yeah, I'd be giggling the whole time.
You'd be giggling. I'd be fucking... I'd be passionately looking at you.
You'd have a friend holding a mirror. Yeah.
I'd be trying to get you into it. I'd be like, I know you're giggling. But come on, you feel that? I'm tightening up on it right now. I'm doing Kegels on your dick.
This is giving me an erection right now.
You know those
I open and close
Kegels.
My asshole like a fucking dolphin hole. The benefit to... That's the benefit of having a fucking bidet.
Is that the benefit?
Yeah, and the water going in your ass like a fucking water dick.
Oh, wow. Does it feel good? No joke. Does it feel good?
A bidet
is the best.
Never mind getting the job.
Now I have a new one. I had to.
You have the 6,000.
I have the 300.
Okay,
but 3,000.
I saw you on TV.
But the old one I had, I liked a lot. This new one has it's called an enema function.
Enema function.
And basically, what the enema
function for when it's date night.
What the enema function does is that it gets up in there.
Yeah.
Okay, and it literally power sands. It power
Jesus Christ.
It like gets up there like when they're mining with just water on the side of a fucking mountain.
Wow.
God, I would be so tempted to videotape it.
Well,
you think he hasn't?
You can't because if you get off the seat,
no,
it shuts down.
I would need help.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. I see.
If you get up,
your wife's? Was it yours?
No, this is Bobby's.
You got it for yourself?
Because Joey Cola, who I love and one of the nicest comics on the planet Earth,
who you would fuck?
No, I would never fuck
okay.
Joey.
Okay,
no.
All right.
That's not nice.
No offense. I love
okay.
Joey.
Just not like
tone
that.
Again.
We're just fine.
he explained to me one time that, if you're using dried toilet paper on your asshole, you're spreading peanut butter.
Sure, of course.
So it doesn't make sense. It's
he
the only
takes a shower after every shit.
Yeah, there's
no.
There's a lot of people who do that.
Obviously, if it's practical, if I'm at,
what?
if I'm out and about, yeah. I don't use the sink.
If you're at McDonald's, you don't
weird.
Run in there and hop up on the sink and
right.
splash water in your ass like a bird.
If you're
fountain.
A gas station, you rent a shower.
Right.
And
I use the squeegee.
Yeah.
That's why he's so excited about the truck stops.
Right. He's going to shit and then shower.
I found if I'm home or I'm at my studio and I shit, I jump in the shower.
Wow.
I'm out faster than somebody who wipes their ass would be out.
That's
amazing.
So, all right,
one song Johnny over here.
Yeah, so I love it. It's one of the best things. Because it cleans you.
I'm a fan of cleaning.
I still use a little toilet paper at the end just to make sure.
Sure.
You know, just a little dab just to make sure.
A little dab will do.
Dude, it is. And now I use the Squatty Potty thanks to
love Squatty Potty.
Howard Stern and Dan Soda.
That's amazing.
I love it.
It's
I
so
have,
good.
I shit like a fucking champion.
I have my wife hold my legs up.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. Well, we're in the honeymoon phase, you know.
That was nine jokes I wanted to make, but I don't, because your wife was involved, I pulled
She's
back.
Sweet. Thank you.
But now, okay, back to the transgender. It's
yeah,
trans.
Talk about
okay,
shit.
Okay, so now you have, now for you, you had to, did you just, how do you find out about?
I'll tell you the
please.
Story.
She fell
okay.
in love with him.
Please.
So yeah. So here's what happened. So when Lauren and I first started sleeping with each other,
Hold on, let me get my dick out. Yeah.
Could you?
I want to read this DraftKings ad again.
Wait.
Hey man.
You guys have dicks?
I have
DraftQueens.com.
Mine's actually technically a pud. Like there's a pickle and then there's a gherkin.
Gherkin.
Go ahead.
Okay. So when we first started it, like I had. Sort of been with women, maybe I made out or something. It always felt queer, but it was like fun because I'm a sexual person. So it's like, yay, we're just doing this thing. But at the end of it, I was like, where's like the dude or whatever. So when we first started sleeping with each other, it was fucking phenomenal. Fall asleep right after, sort of like satiated. Yes, all of those things. Keep going. Yep.
Everything Keith wasn't.
Yeah. Especially after years of terrible sex.
Every day.
Just subpar.
Relax.
I fucked Keith. I was up eating Wheat Thins and watching old movies.
Wheat Thins.
Let's just say Lauren doesn't tell me to relax during sex. Anyway.
Easy. I'm not liking this. Relax.
You will like this. Anyway, so and I'm telling him at the time he identified as a lesbian but didn't connect with it, didn't really like it, but we didn't know why. So, but I didn't even know that, right? And I'm thinking like, hey, this is going really well, but I'm warning you, usually this isn't my thing, but this is amazingly going well. Okay, then one time, this is about like the third, fourth, I don't know, fifth time we had sex, right after I was just like, I gotta tell you something. This might be weird to say, but you don't feel like a woman. You feel like a dude, fuck like a dude.
Shit.
Like, it's very, I don't know how to put it. And then he starts crying, and I'm like, who says this?
Wait,
while
did,
everyone's
did he
start like,
slow capping himself?
That's
fucking right. Baby.
Wait,
that's what that because that's the victory right
yeah,
there. He's
yeah.
like, you're goddamn right. I don't feel like a fucking
There's
woman.
There's a little string on the roof, and he goes,
all the balloons start coming down.
That's the funniest thing because you said the same thing to Keith, right?
Yeah. You feel
I
like a man.
To,
you don't feel like.
So I said that, he starts crying, I'm like, oh my God, I don't know what I just said. And he goes, no, something about that, you see me. He goes, sees a mutual friend of ours, is just hanging out, and he's like, this is what happened between me and Chemda. And our friend Emmy goes, yeah, you're trans then, like this is the word for it, here's a book about it. And then Lauren reads this book and it is his life story. You know, like sometimes you hit something and you're like, of course I was being misidentified, I never really connected with the lesbian community, like I understood, you know, it was helpful for what it was because they're, you know, they're welcoming and there's like an element that we're all understanding about it. But so this happened, and then from there we learned more about it, and it's easier to transition. Now we only use male pronouns, and everyone identifies him as male.
Do
who's
get,
a friend?
Do you ever fuck up though? Do you ever slip?
Yeah,
I
but
go,
I
bitch,
slip.
I mean, fuck. I call Keith a bitch too, I swear. You know
what? Men are the biggest fucking bitches, so you will all be called a bitch at one point.
Now, do you, does that bring, seriously, does that bring you to like men? Are you a man hater? Does that make you guys?
No.
Do you, you said
you just
that
said
with a
men
tongue.
Are the biggest bitches.
Yes, I did.
Do you not like men as much as you used to? Do you?
No, I wish I didn't. I always wished I didn't love men. You guys are like, I mean, it's a lot easier to get along with your sex, I think. It's right. Like this natural, you do think differently, and so it matches. I love my female friends, but the truth is I'm
They're
attracted
bitches.
To men, and that's just the way it is.
Right.
It just seems like...
Wow, dude! Were you even listening?
But
It is like
I love that Keith forego the mic for the rest. Yeah. He doesn't even care about that shit. He's such a pro podcaster. I don't need mics. Yeah. I use my voice.
He fucking does have that day. Like, no, great. When I walked in, like, and you guys were going, that's what I was thinking. I was like, yo, these three fucking know how to. You guys do it every day. I was like, they know how to go.
Yeah.
Thank you.
But like, so it's just because that's the first time I've heard. Like, it's an interesting thing because it just seems like. Functionally, if you identify,
do me a favor, push the glasses up so we can we can hear you.
Actually,
congratulations.
Functionally,
Uncle Gary.
All right. Everybody shut the fuck up. it is weird because.
Please let the
ask
young
a
man
goddamn
talk.
Question.
I'm sorry,
there
should buddy.
Be a buzzer. Trying to learn.
Time limit. Buddy,
to
I'm sorry. You know what?
Thank you.
Dick gavel. Go ahead.
Thank you.
Come on, you. Fucking stocky Russian.
I'm Greek. How dare you? But what is, I mean, what's the difference at that point of just, not, I can't even actually ask the question anymore.
Right,
like,
this is on
you know what? I don't want to know.
Don't waste your time.
Come on.
No,
ahead.
I mean, it just seems like pretty much that's what a lesbian, I mean, I know this is sort of ignorant, but it's
spit
like,
it out. Just say it.
I'm fucking saying
you.
It right now.
Spit
do
it
I
out.
Really look like assistant manager at a grocery?
Yeah, you do. I'm sorry. That was what I was trying to get at. But yeah, what is the difference then, like functionally, mm-hmm. when you're not transitioning out of the body, like you stay
is this
female
a
body?
Fucking town hall meeting or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, I'm trying to fucking learn, you there fucking idiots. I'm sorry.
Can I ask my next question, professor?
So what is
in
what
this gender question? Studies yeah. class?
You're saying it. You're a little nervous saying it. Just, yeah. just
no,
say
no.
It,
I'm just saying. What's the difference? Like if you stay. If it basically seems like the only difference is like the pronouns. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like if you stay.
Look at Bobby.
Female I'm body and but so what I just that's it. What I'm asking is like what how
the
does that
the difference is okay the difference is
I've never given the bomb bandana for just a serious question.
Fuck you ignorant assholes. I'm trying to learn.
I know, stop putting it on learning. Yeah. By
I'm
the
trying
way.
To learn.
Stop making it.
I've got an open mind unlike you assholes.
I have the most open mind in the world.
No. Here's my impression of that question. So it's sort of like it seems like sort of there's like a thing with like so what's it's if it's like
don't bail him out don't
good
bail
question,
him out don't bail him out with a laugh
do you know he's
it's like
he's,
it's he, like but what, you know
I'm gonna fucking murder I literally want to hang myself this stuttering fucking prick okay fucking but go back with the he she we okay. de woo how
so
do
a
you?
Man I respect and a woman I respect with these things said
all right well I don't think that's
oh God! You fucking mumbling.
I don't know what your question was. Still,
okay.
Really
what's
it?
We're
just spit it out. I didn't know.
Say it. Say it with an Italian accent. It will come out easier. Yeah.
You think so?
How do you fucking
so
quiz? Do you guys suck each other's dicks? Is there a dick involved? Just say it.
I know you're telling me she's a guy, but there's two fucking pussies in the room. So
yeah, it just seems like
how's it not
yeah,
a lesbian
that,
experience?
What I'm saying is like, it's the first time I
thanks, Scopo.
He's trying to say that, but he wants to be, you know, he wants to say it right. But
yeah, it just seems like. It just seems like what is the difference then in fuck
as,
you dickheads.
As
I'm not asking.
Se,
I don't give a fuck.
For
I don't care
tooth,
anymore.
Though.
You've stopped a person's curiosity.
What's the difference
happy.
If you were licking a girl's pussy and your husband's pussy?
Okay, so
is that the question, Stavros?
Giving the blowjob, what is it?
The aforementioned is the client.
I'm gonna just look up some articles alone at home without this scrutiny. I don't need
good.
To
I hope it's alone.
I'm gonna ask Jeeves. I'm gonna ask Jeeves these questions.
I hope you it's alone. You don't annoy your new roommate. Yeah. You fucking booted out.
Are you asking because there's a little certain someone you want to know how to approach the right way?
Yeah.
Mm. Yes.
Someone.
Just
what are you
me,
getting
man.
At
just
there?
Just ask me.
Now, no joke, Kenda. Do you have
just
any idea
me.
What he's talking about?
Yeah.
See, thank you. You dickheads didn't know. The person I'm trying to communicate with did a half hour ago.
Let's see if she fucking knows.
He wants to know what's the difference between identifying as a lesbian and identifying as a trans man.
Is that true?
When
yes.
you're not transitioning.
Thank
physically.
You. Oh my God.
Oh, wow.
See
wow.
that?
That is how you ask
see?
The
that only smart person in the room knew what I was talking Oof. About.
Yeah, but she said it like a fucking human being.
Yeah.
Well, you said it like a guy who's dying. He really did. He talked like he just took a bullet. I want to ask you one last thing to tell.
I
hope your first child is a masculine and lesbian is different.
I hope your first child is a trans child. I'm Luca Brasi.
Here's, I don't, you know, I can't fully, I am not trans, mm-hmm. but here's one of the differences. Imagine you're going through puberty and everyone's getting, let's say, I don't know what's important to you at the time. Let's say everyone's getting chest hair and that's identifying everybody in your crowd as male. And so you keep getting misidentified as female and everyone's, you know, calling you she and calling you by these names that you don't identify with. It hurts you so much
yeah.
that there are people actually killing themselves
right.
because there is a difference.
That's
so whether
thing.
You understand where the line actually is, you know that there is a line. And when you get misidentified, I mean, maybe you could relate it to your name and people, you know, constantly mispronouncing your name.
He keeps thinking you're Italian. He sees it all the time.
What you just said is what bothers me. Even if you don't believe in it, even if you don't buy what you're saying, even if you're like that a woman's a woman, a man's a man, blah blah blah. When somebody's
that's
feeling
that's dangerous too, but okay.
Well, if you yeah. if there's people that believe in that,
of course.
But here's the thing: we're all human beings. If someone's feelings are hurt, if someone's sad about something, if someone's really troubled and they just want to be recognized as that, or they believe something and it kills them inside to have other people treat them that way, why would you do it? Who, what the fuck? Even if you don't believe in it, even if your religion, whatever your thing is, why would you want somebody to hurt? I don't get that.
But
I don't care about it.
Furthermore, why wouldn't you think that it's an awesome thing? Variety it's always good.
Yeah, but you're coming
it's
at it from.
Good.
So, I get it.
I like that.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
always good.
It is. Why would you want Kanye West for president?
That's variety.
But that's not real. That's not reality. What you're saying is right, but it's not reality.
It will absolutely be,
because we've come so far so fast.
Oh, yeah.
And I know what people are. Well, it needs to be faster, of course. But I mean,
I want you to imagine this. I'm the only woman in the room, so maybe I'll be the only. But maybe you have some.
Wait,
female
you don't know
that.
You don't know how we identify.
First of all, I want to say something. My CB radio name is not Two-Ton Tessie.
I told you.
It's Kathleen Borsetti. It's my mother's name.
Imagine if you're female, a man that will never make fun of your period because he knows how fucking fucked up it is.
It's awesome.
Because he gets one too.
Yeah, that's fucking awesome.
Oh,
that's
shut
pretty
up,
cool.
Yannis.
That
is.
That's not awesome.
It is awesome.
Not, you don't have a wife.
Who's the millennial now?
Yeah, wait until you have a wait till you have a wife that's fucking
from the bottom of
your asshole.
I like
think
it,
that's
Yannis.
Fucking
thank you.
Awesome.
No, Yannis is saying
yeah, it's awesome.
Because I know how hacky it is, but I have to keep joking about it. No, I wish I was more evolved.
Yeah,
no.
You like it because you're half woman because you have fucking Mauricio.
No,
I have always been fascinated with people who were born in the wrong body. It's something that is a reality, and it creates variation within. Look, there's no urgent need for us to reproduce. In this society, there's too many people on the fucking planet. Gay people are the most natural.
I don't agree with that,
yes,
dude.
Yes,
no, first of all, you don't know that because you never fucking reproduce. I fucking made a life, and when you make a life with somebody that you give a fuck about, it's one of the most amazing things.
I didn't say it wasn't.
Yeah, but you were saying that we don't need
it.
To make fucking.
Well, we don't. From a mathematical perspective.
I'm saying from a natural perspective.
People a natural
say,
perspective.
People say
you should.
I hate when people say it's unnatural. First of all, what is unnatural? What is outside of nature? Everything.
Well,
you know
what's
funny is
they're not saying
they're
that
it's natural.
What they're saying is straight sex is natural, which means politicians are going, it's better if you put a dick in your mouth than like something else.
No,
like,
no.
It's how you get off. It's how you bust it out. Who cares who you're doing
that's
with?
That's not true.
Who are you going to tell me who to love?
That's not true. That's not true. Scientifically, okay? Scientifically.
You're going down a road you may not know about.
Hang on. Scientifically.
I think I just told you to relax.
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 But I said it the way you should say it. Relax. I care about you. Relax. I really don't want you to find. Hey, whatever you need. Do you need me right now? Because I'll help you relax. What I'm saying is that you sperm is to make a life. A penis is shaped and goes in a vagina, and jizz comes out, and there's an egg inside
or
of
you
there.
Can swallow
and you
it.
Can, you're not supposed to swallow it. You're just not
why
supposed.
Not?
To.
Don't you ever say
you're not
that.
I'm not saying,
honey.
I'm not saying
hang
that.
Up the, hang,
hang
up
on.
The radio.
Hang on. I'm not saying that.
Hang up the radio.
I'm not saying that you're. I'm not saying that you're not supposed to. You can do whatever you want. I don't care. I'm not
no,
saying
you're
these
buying,
are my.
You're
these
buying
are my
into
beliefs.
It.
These are my beliefs. I'm not saying these are my beliefs. I'm saying you can swallow jizz. You can do whatever. But I'm saying, It's scientific that sperm makes a life. It goes in the vagina, okay?
Yeah.
And you're supposed to make a baby with it. What we've done with it, okay, what we evolved with it is fine.
We didn't evolve with
dude,
it. Like, no,
no we were always
at,
like,
look
we
at
were always
the Bonobo chicks. I don't, all they do is have sex totally. All day.
Do they swallow each other's
they
jizz?
They have homosexual
do
sex.
Do they swallow
which
jizz?
A lot of species do. And
do they
the most,
what animals
they
swallow jizz?
They're the most non-violent species on the planet.
They
because
grow
they're
their
not
jizz.
Sexually fucking
hang
repressed.
On, first of all,
so they're not judging.
Hang on, hang on. He had a great fucking joke. We got to stop. I said, what animal swallows jizz? And he said, the swallow. That was a very clean joke. We got to acknowledge those on these fucking things.
About the dick.
I just don't. I understand why people don't understand it. Do you understand? I get it. I understand why people like, I don't get what the fuck they're talking about. I get it. I'm cool with it. I want you to be happy. Whatever the fuck makes you happy.
But
I don't
here's
care.
The thing. You're getting what you know. We need for people to get that what they don't know personally still exists.
Yeah, how is it more unnatural than putting glasses on? Nature says your glasses, your lies go.
Right, or God fucked up. You have people being born.
But we
you have people being born, no exaggeration, with literally three heads. God or nature makes fucking mistakes, right? Or makes something weird, or makes something different that you don't know.
I never called anybody a mistake. Right. I don't know what you're saying.
Amen.
You need
now
to
Bobby's
fucking
turning
relax.
On you.
No, you see, you know, the glasses thing, first of all, doesn't make sense. We became more intelligent. We learned how to fly. We learned how to drive. We learned how to fucking make glasses. I don't know what that has to do with any of this.
We're a species of technology.
Well, we evolve. We're smart. We evolve.
We invented the bidet.
I'm saying if you're going to call something unnatural,
yes,
glasses would be a prime candidate for the definition of what people would consider unnatural. Glasses would
no,
be a prime
but
candidate
but but you but what I'm
you guys
saying
are talking about two different things.
Yeah, we absolutely are. Yeah. He's talking about something else.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is that
you're responding to two different things.
People don't understand it. People under look. You make a baby.
People
you do this.
Understand it. They're just hypocrites about it.
That's not true,
they're
man.
They're hypocrites about
that's
it.
That's not true.
Everyone except like this. Sexuality is a scale, and there's some people who are ultra heterosexual. Some people who are ultra homosexual. Everyone else falls about the middle. They have some sort of thought here and there. All women, most of women masturbate
yeah, but you're
to lesbian
just,
porn.
I don't like that you're just
so
saying the way
woman.
It is. You're not listening. You're just
I'm
fucking
listening.
Talking.
I'm just, no, I'm giving my perspective.
Yeah, but your perspective is a fucking fact. I mean,
it is a fact.
It is not a fact. To you, it's a fact.
Why would I say it if it's not?
Okay. What I'm saying is that I think a lot of people don't understand. I come from an Irish Catholic family that doesn't understand. Not that they hate gay people. They had to learn how they're learning through people like her or through Caitlyn Jenner. What the fuck's going on? Like people are like, what the fuck is that? And then they start hearing the stories. They start listening to the interviews and they start doing research. And then they're like, yeah. I don't, it's okay, I get it, or she's cool, and because we're being exposed to it.
Right.
It's like a black president. That was fucking 100 years ago, that was fucking, are you fucking nuts?
Right.
You know, but you have to learn about that. You have to be subjected to it. You can't just assume that people fucking get it because we were taught this is what it was, religious-based.
Right. Right.
You make a life. You fucking have babies. Now, I don't think everybody should have a baby. Maybe you never have a kid. I'm cool with that. I think having a kid is one of the most amazing things on the fucking planet.
The fuck
but
that?
If you don't, that's fine. I'm cool with that, right. too. But having making a life is fucking insane. Okay? Insane.
Yeah, and a lot of people have to do it to keep it going.
A lot of people, you don't have to. But it's something that you want to do. When my wife said, do you want to make a baby? I was like, why are we going to make a baby? Like, what is the purpose of it? Is this some selfish, weird thing to have a mini-me to see what I will look like? You know what I'm saying? What are we doing? Is this to merge our fucking... We finally came to the conclusion that we wanted to have our own family.
Right. You made a choice.
We made a choice to have a family. You know what I mean? To have our own family. I got my mother's over here. She's got her parents over here. She goes there for Christmas, blah, blah. We're gonna have our own family. We're gonna have our own traditions. We're gonna start something, and we're gonna take all the shit that happened to us, all the misinformation that happened, all the bad things, and eliminate it and raise something better. We're actually making the world fucking a better place because my son is going to fucking respect people. He's not going to get beaten. He's not going to be told he was stupid. He's going to have the same dad his whole fucking life. He's going to stay in the same schools. He's going to have a fucking beautiful mom. And his mom and dad are going to love each other and show that in front of him. And his mom and dad are also acceptive of black people. We have Bailey, Jay, and Matt are over the house more than any friend I have. He's going to know a transgender woman in the family. And a man that dates them, and they're married. He's going to understand that. So I made the world a fucking better place by jizzing in a fucking vagina.
So who can top that? Can you, four eyes?
I just don't, I'm sorry. I don't mean to, I just don't like when people throw baby fucking, like, people with babies. I didn't say that.
To play devil's advocate there, you could have adopted a kid and done the same stuff.
I adopted you. And I'm doing that with you.
And I fucked this one up, and so now I'm trying with a new baby.
What'd you say?
He's got to leave.
Where are you going?
I
got
to do a quick set.
Where?
Right down the street.
Oh, really? Come back.
I'll come back, yeah.
I will say this, though.
I love you, Yannis, by the way.
I love it. It is beautiful that Caitlyn Jenner is explaining things to people, but I'll be goddamn that now I gotta respect the Kardashians.
Right? What did you think of the Bill Burr outrage, fucking manufactured outrage, when he was on Conan last week or 2 weeks ago, and he's talking to Conan, and he was doing it as a bit. He really was getting worked up and saying, you know, I didn't get to say goodbye. You know, I really,
it's
I miss
fucking
Bruce
hilarious.
Jenner. It was really, really funny.
I just think people wanted to come after him. He just talked about her.
Like,
that was
he knew what he was doing. He was generating.
He never
he
said anything negative about her.
It was funny, yeah,
but it was really clever.
That's hilarious.
What he was doing.
Do you think that's funny?
I think Bill Burr is one of the funniest people on earth.
Agreed.
I don't always agree with everything he says.
That's why he's one of the funniest people.
But I absolutely respect that he says it, and he says it from an intelligent space.
Totally.
And it sounds like an ape man, but
in
it's clearly beautiful.
She hates muffin punchers. So
what Bill?
I saw that. Right. I saw that thing. Yeah. I thought, I understand why it's funny. I understand where he's coming from.
Yeah, he's being facetious.
Here's why people didn't like it.
Right.
Because he clearly doesn't fully get what transgender means and what she actually did.
Right.
And I don't think that you need that in comedy all the time to, like,
fully,
you know, translate to people. I don't think that he needs to be on a pedestal explaining transgender to people. The people responding didn't think it was funny because if you understand what transgender is, it actually technically wasn't funny.
Right.
Because once we learn a little bit more, you'll understand that that isn't where the joke is. There is a joke there.
Yeah, I think.
But it's not. I get why people are up in arms.
Yeah.
I get when you're being misidentified constantly and then, you know, a giant guy continues to do that and he, you know, he has this very particular following that's also going to mismatch what he's saying with like some other bullshit.
Yeah.
I get it, but it's passing. It's going to pass.
Yeah.
It passes. And it's just another reason to bring up this topic and to have this conversation. It's fine, and we need to move on. And I think the next transgender joke he tells is going to be even better, and he's only going to get better. No, he shouldn't shut the fuck up in general because he told a joke that maybe isn't funny to some people.
Right.
That's it. It's just not going to be funny to you.
That's the one thing, though. It is really, you know, whatever group you make fun of, whatever, there's people inside of that group that just can't take it.
Sure.
They just can't take it
because
they will find something offensive in it. It's so serious.
Hack,
it's so serious to them.
Hack,
no, it wasn't. No, absolutely.
But
not.
The topic.
Giving himself the butt of
but the
joke,
topic
right?
is so serious to them that it's not funny.
I agree.
Right.
There are some times where, like, there are some people who cannot listen to rape jokes because they were horrifically raped, or their mother was, or their sister was, or whatever. Doesn't matter. Or they just obviously rape is a terrible thing.
Right.
You don't go to see the comedian who does rape jokes, and if he does, you understand that that is not for you, and enjoy the black jokes that he's
but
making.
But there's also
you're okay with the black jokes.
Yeah.
You're okay with the Jew jokes he just told.
Right. So you've seen Bobby.
Well, the Jew jokes are hilarious.
There's no bad Jew joke.
But I mean, no, it's.
I mean, when you rule the world, make some jokes about us.
Are we going on 3 hours?
Oh shit.
No, that's just what your ticker says.
Oh,
we're
okay.
about two, two and ten.
Okay, good. I think but even in the transgender community, they're careful what they say because trans people get attacked for joking. Like you'll say the wrong word, and they'll like. There's comics, and there's people like Bailey does podcasts. She has to be careful what she says because they'll go after her. And she's
for not representing them.
For not representing or saying the right thing. Look, there's people who are. It's just not funny. It's just
Well, Lauren gets shit from some of the trans community because he's not transitioning, and they're like, well, are you really trans?
Right.
Well, were you really trans before you transitioned?
You
yes,
can't win.
You were.
You can't win. You can't win 100% of the time. There's always a there's always a group that is going to have something to say.
But also, do you have to worry, like, I guess not, right? You got to live your life. But do you have to understand now transgender is the thing? How about the comic right after the Civil War? You got to be careful what jokes you make.
I also think,
well,
like,
we made jokes about September 11th that Thursday. Yeah.
But you got to know a little bit of your audience. You got to know what will make them laugh. And if you tell a 9/11 joke that's completely tasteless, you're telling a hack joke that nobody wants to laugh at. So you can't blame the audience for that. That's your terrible joke. But if you tell a good 9/11 joke, people will laugh despite themselves.
You
want
to hear a good 9/11 joke?
Oh, man, there's so many good ones.
Pete Corelli comes. He has a joke. This is right after 9/11.
Right.
And he goes, my relatives are coming in town. They want to go down and see the friggin', you know, the site. So, I took them to a construction site over by my house. I was like, the buildings are right there. They're like, oh, really? You're taking snapshots. Is that hilarious?
I love the Louis one. If you can tell a lot about a person by how long they waited to masturbate after 9/11, and for him it was between the first and the second tower.
Jesus Christ.
He did that 2 weeks after.
I think that it is, I've been learning about it for the last 4 years. Ever since I met Bailey.
9/11?
No.
Bailey does a lot of 9/11.
Dude, pick up a fucking paper.
Yeah, Chatfield doesn't melt still
days. Not a big reader.
I've learned about it, and that's why, like, when you say he, that's shocking to me. It's jarring because I'm like, huh? Oh, okay. I don't know what to say. And then I'm like, okay, this is it. Now, I'm better tonight with you and your marriage with him. It comes out better now. It's like him, okay.
Right.
It just comes out better now.
Next time you see him, you'll see him more as him.
Right.
Why didn't your husband change his name? Lauren's a very feminine name.
Well, now Lauren is. I mean, you know, he's
Lauren
an
Michael.
Actor. He's built like LaurenHennessy.com.
Right.
And
she's in the chat, by the way.
Is she?
She's been talking.
I mean,
Fuck.
Whoa! I'm sorry. I love how your non-mic skills are fucking brilliant.
he
is in the chat.
Oh, yeah, he's in the chat. He says, fuck y'all, fuck you. Wrong,
bro. No, it's because I mean, I've met you guys. Of course, I know him. And it's something that it's almost like a learning curve that my whole life I've been, this is what it is. This is what relationships are. This is what you do. And then all of a sudden I'm subjected to real people who are different than me, and I'm like, whoa, what the fuck's going on? And it's not just she-males. It's not. There's so
not
many
chicks with dicks.
Yeah, it's so many fucking layers to it, and there's so much about it that you just don't understand. And now it's all being revealed in front of us in my life with you and with on TV and it's not just. You know, Caitlyn Jenner. It's not just Bailey. It's not just you.
I tell the people who still don't understand it, there is a BuzzFeed video that was done about us that I think, you know, tells like a when people need a story,
right.
You know, mm-hmm. to sort of understand. It's 4 minutes. KeithandTheGirl.com/buzz
right.
for BuzzFeed, BUZZ. It just says about how that works a little
right.
bit. Like
yeah.
It's a good video.
Yeah.
It's a good
just
video.
A little story about.
All right, good. I'll check that out.
Yeah.
All right, good. Well, listen, first of all, I appreciate you guys coming on. That was real. I feel bad. I got fucking heated. I just
had to leave.
I get heated, and I should really not get heated. I love Yannis to death.
That didn't seem so crazy.
No.
Yeah, but it just when sometimes
he's Greek. That's how we talk.
Well, it's
I lump myself in it because I'm Mediterranean too.
You can pass.
Yeah. Well, sometimes when people talk about people with kids, like you don't. I'm like I used to be that.
Right.
You know what I mean? And now I'm this, and I have some empathy for parents.
Can I tell you? He wasn't talking about you. Can I tell you where he was coming from?
Where
he. He was saying, and this was like completely not you, that when people talk about the queer community, they talk about it not being natural because queers can't make babies.
Yeah.
And he was saying the most natural thing is to not make a baby because it's just the same as this other thing.
I don't understand that, though. It's not, I mean, it's. I think it's a natural thing to make a life.
But it's natural also to not make a life.
Because
natural some to people make are right-handed.
To fuck a woman.
Some people are left-handed.
To fuck a woman and... to not come in her. is not
That's
natural.
Unnatural, bro.
It's not natural. I'm serious. You have to literally fight every bone
in
your body.
I've had so much unnatural sex with men.
Right, but and there's seriously, if we're having sex. Any woman, it's like, fuck, I want to come. And I have to fight every bone in my body to go, I'm going to pull the fuck out right
now. What he was saying is that if you're same sex, you don't have to do that, and that's natural. It's natural that same sex people don't have to do that.
Okay, but you have to. So what is he saying? You can come in.
Come anywhere, baby.
Oh, my God. DraftKings.com. At DraftKings.com, use the code word Kelly.
Is this what they want to be associated with?
Yeah.
Yes.
Fine, why not?
Who doesn't want to be?
What's wrong with you?
No, come, not trans.
I think I got it wrong. I think Yannis was saying, fuck your family.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
I'm pretty sure he just said fuck your family.
Yeah, he explicitly said you're a terrible parent.
It's an amazing thing to, as a man who's used your dick as a, just for me.
A weapon, I mean.
Just for me.
To hurt people.
I've used my dick to fucking blow loads and to feel good for a couple seconds.
Sure.
My whole life.
That's natural, too.
By the way, you get to count that first minute until you come, you know. You get the whole minute to count.
I get 6 seconds.
Keep telling yourselves that.
But to make this baby and all of a sudden, I mean, dude, it's unspeakable to me how fucking dramatic and emotional it is to look down at this. Dude, when he comes, he goes, hi. When I come home, he goes, hi. That was jizz. Nice. He was in my nut. And then I put him in a vagina. And now he looks like me and he loves me. And I'm teaching him and I'm learning from him. And it's like, this is fucking nuts. This is what we did, what happened to us. I mean, we were that little thing. And now.
Oh, God, I'm thinking my parents.
But
the off mic king.
he really is. It's just amazing. But I just think that it's amazing. So when I hear people, I get a little bit. But I love Yannis to death. Anyways, let's go to the chat room. It really is a curve you have to learn. It's something you have to train your brain to.
It took me a while, naturally.
It really? Yeah. I mean, okay, cool. Good.
So it's he.
It's right? He.
Yeah.
Lauren had
think about him like you think about other people.
But don't
like
say
it's
it.
Man.
Yeah, don't say it like you're annoyed. What the fuck?
So
it's he.
You're all about tone.
Can I say something? Tone is important.
Tone is important.
It's not.
You never say, hey, him. You know, you just got to talk natural.
Right.
Well, Lauren was fielding a lot of questions from the other people in the chat.
Thank you.
Wow. I think he goes by Hennessy now, too, just to stop that kind of... he goes by Hennessy a lot of times, yeah.
Cool. Scopo's cool tired name. As That's shit. We got to get him to bed.
Well, Lauren was fielding a lot of questions, and then someone asked what his favorite Bowie song is, which I thought was funny. And just a lot of back and forth. Buddy says...
Yeah, go ahead.
Stavros... I wore those glasses in 1981. Someone says
retro.
That.
Yeah, that's why he's wearing them. Cause fucking, you can't find them unless you're at a flea market in Poughkeepsie.
They're $12 on Zenni.com. That's why I wear them. Cheapest glasses you could buy.
All right, well that too. Fucking non-funny, serious. Now we feel bad for you.
I'm sorry. I'm tired too.
All right, you're tired, Bubba?
You're working. You're not allowed to be tired. What's this diet?
What is this diet?
I woke up
in front of you.
7 o'clock in the morning, I woke up.
You know
six.
What?
I was up
if
at
you
six.
Woke up at 5 in the morning. Wake the fuck up.
Right, one second. Don't ever trump me. Either one of you. I say 7. You say
relax.
7.
You don't give me 2 hours earlier.
I'm so tired. I still have to talk.
What did she say?
She's so brutal.
What did she say?
All this sitting down and talking.
What did he say? You fucking dumb Bobby.
I didn't have any of that stuff queued up. It was, like, directed at other people. Sorry, bud.
Whoa!
Sorry. That's what we're doing.
You're looking pretty far.
That tastes like somebody's asshole.
It tastes like
your own hand. Yeah.
Yeah, good?
For the record, he put the gavel
that
penis
was,
in his mouth.
Was on. Oh, he
that
got it.
That was hot.
Yeah, all right, so
some people are listening
I'm
just to audio.
Can we make that a GIF?
A gift to me.
I literally just almost passed out. All right, listen, one thing that's great
that
is...
That was unnatural.
The show didn't crash.
Hey,
there we go.
I don't know if Michael fix it.
Congrats on the new studio. It's amazing.
The computer,
amazing.
Thank you very much.
I understand you had some comics here. The day after you put it together, they're shitting on them. That's what you do when you surround yourself with assholes. You're going to get that problem. This is a beautiful fucking studio. You should be proud.
Thank you very much. And you know what? It means a lot. Because I remember when I did your show and I walked in, I was like, holy shit. these guys, I was doing it on my kitchen table at the time. Where, you know, and I had an iPhone, and then I move up to a mixer, and I was like, oh, my God. And, you know, I remember walking into your studio and be like, holy fuck, this is actually their studio. This is their place. And it was amazing. So thank you very much. I'm very proud.
Congrats.
I'm proud of Deepu, and I'm proud of fucking Scopo, Kelly Festuca, and every comic that's been on the show that made the show popular. And, of course, the Comedy Cellar gnome, Liz, Tony, and his crew.
Kelly's been listening
Mike,
in, by the way.
Kelly. Mean, everybody's a part of this.
By the way, Robert, since you're accepting an award, here it is. A giant program.
Can I say something?
From 2055.
I'll tell you, you're so on the money with my shit. I just yapping asshole. We got married. We're literally live streaming it on the Maui beach.
Okay.
I walk up the cameras. We just got married, blah, 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 walking over to the cameras. The guy's there. I go, I just want to say thank you to, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I'm going on with my
caterer,
fucking yapping. Yeah. She goes, what are you, accepting an award? My wife, who just married me, literally told me to shut my face.
And
5 seconds.
And you loved her even more.
Yeah, and then I jizzed in her.
It's so natural.
Let's go around the room real quick. Stavros, what do you got?
So I guess this is next weekend. I'm at Gotham with Tom Papa.
And you're going to have to make a decision soon.
And then
look at me.
But you're my two dads. I can't.
That's a sitcom.
Yeah, that's not a bad sitcom.
That
there we go. Let's write that.
He's all about
two
the two people,
dads,
right? So. Remember?
Yeah. And then I'm wherever Bobby takes me after that.
Oh. Okay.
Good one, bro. Nice.
What do you got?
We have our tour we're very proud of. KeithandTheGirl.com/tour. Get your tickets now if you're by one of the cities. Promise you'll have fun.
All right, calm down.
I promise.
So relax
you
a little bit.
Also, I've never made another a promise in my life. Even when me and Chemda dated, I never promised a fucking thing.
Who are the comics on your show?
Well, we actually are going to travel with some people. So Lauren Hennessy is coming.
Nice.
Newsy Jerome Charles. I don't know. These are people that are like our fans of. So Ray DeVito, who I think you guys know.
Yeah, he's great.
I do know. He's funny.
Yeah.
Catherine Heller and our own Danny Hatch, who is our associate producer. Then we would get to like the Comedy Store. We have Jesse Joyce, who's from At Midnight.
Very funny.
We have Paul F. Tompkins.
Oh,
wow. Zach Sherwin. And up in like San Francisco, we have Marga Gomez. And we're still building the lineup like for locals.
Right.
And so we'll have like local sort of like celebs and stuff. And
cool.
We're traveling together. And okay. We're also recording it for a documentary. KeithandTheGirl.com/tour.
That's cool. Great. That's great. Great. You guys are fucking goddamn entrepreneurs.
We're excited.
It's madness.
Yeah, it's great, man.
I forgot to plug my erotic Instagram account at Stavvy Baby, Stavvy Baby.
I think I just
threw
up
serious.
In my mouth.
Will you send me a link?
I totally will. Stavvy Baby.
I like
and
all the
also,
photos, Stavros.
Thank you. Thank you, Scopo. And then also just Twitter at Stav Comedy. But please, Stavvy Baby. I'm trying to get it off the ground.
Yeah, all right.
Oh,
get
yeah.
That.
And you can follow my weight loss at Chemda.
Fatmass.com.
Jesus, Will is a fucking. I really feel bad about this art lamp.
Oh, God.
I like it now.
My goodness, how do you sleep at night?
I don't.
You can't possibly.
I feel bad. I mean, I felt bad that we trashed him.
You're going to feel bad until you go outside and some old lady is like, where the fuck is my lamp? I mean,
what do you got, Jay? Besides beautiful hair.
I have beautiful hair. I'm hosting a big show tomorrow night, Trainwreck Comedy in Times Square. I've got Meek Kaplan and Zach Schoen. Regina
Kaplan.
Did. We've got a good lineup. Meek Kaplan.
Mike?
Yep.
I've always said Meek.
It looks like
Meek. Because you're an idiot.
You've gotten away with it because of the accent,
yeah,
but
accent,
you're mispronouncing
it. So I
kind of
get away with it. Yeah. Say, hey, Meek. And he's like, hi. Yeah.
He's like, he knows better now, and he's like, I got to stick with this forever.
Yeah, exactly. He's never corrected me.
I think I'm having an aneurysm.
Got some, I got some dates in Australia. I'm flying back to Australia on Sunday. I got some dates. Go to Jason Chatfield.
You're going to Australia. You're going home.
Yeah, I got to go and do some gigs. Yeah.
Do me a favor. Well, you've fuck Kelly Festuca while you're there. And when you're done,
sure.
And when you come, go, that's from Bob.
That's from Bob.
Jesus Christ.
See that bit? That's from Bobby.
That jizz in your jabber jab is from
that's
Kelly.
Bobby jizz.
Home Bobby,
that's from my pud.
Bobby wanted to say, when you come, go,
duh.
Scopo, what do you got besides fucking a fat ass?
Aww.
No,
that's a compliment.
I see why you'd love
great hair.
Great hair. He's got better hair than me. Jesus.
That's
basically what I got. nothing. I got nothing coming up the next couple of weeks.
I think I'm going to try to take you with one, all right?
Like this. Yeah, it'd be great. Oh, fantastic.
Okay. Oh, that's a good, calm atmosphere that you have going on after he just said you can come with him. That's really good.
Easy. I said, I think maybe I will one day.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Oh, that sounds fun.
I have some dates. I got to figure it out. Deepu, what do you got?
Oh, you can follow me across the board at R2Deepu. And everything else, my schedule is just empty. So if any of my friends are running rooms, bark up this tree, possibly get up.
I like it.
If any of my friends are running rooms, bark up this tree, possibly get on YKWD. So hit me up.
Oh, you just training your podcast response.
I wouldn't actually,
buddy. I think you think I booked the show.
Oh, shit!
Get some people on this. I gotta give them
hope somehow. But
no, you should book. You should listen. If any of these guys in here need stage time and you have a fucking room, book them. You know. Book him. I want to see you get fucking hilarious. I got to come see you.
Please book me. I just moved.
I want. Oh, will you stop begging, please?
My friend booked.
I don't
want to.
Excuse me. I don't want to do Sundays anymore. Will you please not have me do? Pay me the same money and not have me do Sundays. And I want to fly in on Thursdays. That's my hopes. Okay.
That's good.
What do I got?
Your dates?
Yeah, please.
Is this gonna come out before the 12th of September?
When does your tour start?
October 9th through the 18th.
Yeah, this will be the next. This will be the Monday or next Monday. But
Missing, Pennsylvania. Bobby's coming to Building 24.
It just sounds like a lot.
Go
like
between 23 and 25 and yell, Bobby!
Bus number 6.
And then you're in from the 25th to the 28th. You're at Just for Laughs, Toronto.
Toronto. Nice. That's JFL 42.
You'll see him on the poster.
Well, no, we've worked that out. My bag. I don't. Sometimes you handed a nice piece of humble pie, and Just for Laughs really gave me one. But it really. Anyways. I'm very excited. Uh-huh. I love Just for Laughs. It's a. I've never been a part of this. It's unbelievable. But do me a favor. Go buy tickets. Go buy the pass. You get to see all the shows, and you get to see my show. Go to my website. Click on that. Click on my page. Buy the ticket from there, and come see my show.
You know you're going, so buy now.
Damn. Yeah. I would. I really want to.
He wants to impress him and knock it off your to-do list. Yeah. I mean, this is getting stupid, Bobby. I'm sorry.
Thank you. What else we got? Is that it?
And then you get October 8th, 9th, 10th, you're at the Improv in Fort Lauderdale.
Ooh,
that's pretty hot. Well, easy. All right.
Come on. You need a feature.
Yeah, we'll talk. We're going to talk. I'm fucking flying some fatty out.
I'll be in New Orleans the weekend before, actually.
So you can just get down there.
Yeah.
We'll work that out. That's why I love Stavros. Out of all the guys that's ever middle for me, you just work it out. You're like, yeah dude, I don't give a fuck.
I don't give a fuck. I just want the work. Yeah,
yeah. I need a little money. I pay you, and then you get there yourself.
Yeah.
And you'll fucking take a train home.
I'll hitchhike home, little bindle.
All right. We make sure you watch Sex, Drugs, Rock and Roll Thursday night. There's 3 episodes left.
Proud? You should be proud.
Yeah.
I am very proud of the show, and I'm very proud. I'm happy that people like it. The ratings have been getting great.
It's funny.
Really funny. And the last 3 episodes, last 4, you know, whatever. Last 3, you know, I'm a little more prevalent than I was in the
show. You and John, that B story is really funny.
Yeah, me and John Ailes, who is just a fucking funny guy. He's here now. That's him. He's part of the
he's
fucking.
He's a cool guy.
Yeah, he's in the Chingalings. he's Puerto Rican.
that sounds like an Asian slur.
I got to piss. That almost made me pee my pants. it's an unbelievable show. Me and him kind of do our own thing. And Dennis Leary, Liz Gillies, Elaine Hendricks, John Corbett, who's fucking just gorgeous.
Did he lose weight recently?
He got shredded. Yeah, he's on. Speaking of Greeks, My Big Fat Greek Wedding 2. Mm. He's starring in right now. Wow. So it's the fucking great. We find out very soon if it gets picked up. I hope it does.
Yep.
And we'll see what happens. But make sure you watch it Thursday nights. Retweet, tell everybody, and go to riotcast.com and support all the shows on our network. Just give them a try. It's free. Get down on the app and hit a button and just listen. It's you know, we got we just added another show. We got another show coming on in a month or two, so it's getting bigger and bigger all the time. I think it's up to 20 shows now, and you know, I'm very proud of me, myself and Rob Sprantz and everybody on the network. And that's about it. Anything else?
That's about it.
All right. You know what? Thanks for listening.
You've been listening to the YKWD podcast. Thanks for listening. Now go back to your shitty jobs.
Shitty jobs. Shitty jobs.
Check out riotcast.com for all of the best podcasts on the internet. And they are all free.
And they are all free.